What's up, everyone? It's SuicideShowShow here today. Welcome back to another video. And today we are going to be playing this game called No Good Noelle. It's a recently new game that just came out somewhere around this week. I don't remember. Sorry, I just woke up, I think. So yes, this is a recently new HEO game that I just found on the page. As you can see here, we got these three elves right there, I'm assuming. Those are winter elves, I'm assuming. Yeah, of course. It's some sort of winter-related story about you playing as an elf, and you're like, picking which ones which you are going to go with, I think? Or maybe it's like a friendship-solving situation or whatever, maybe? I don't know. I don't recall as to what this story is basically about, but I guess we're about to find out at some point right there. And, yeah, without further ado, let's see what this one has to serve us right there. Come on, game, let's get us right to it. Ooh, I like the sceneries already, oh my gosh! Two snow sprites are wandering about. Oh, okay. Alright, so we got the character right there. I'm assuming that's us. Our name is Noelle. That's the main character, of course. Hello, Noelle, nice to meet you.
We really shouldn't be this far in.
Right. Oh, okay. And we got this girl. This is Ivy. Hello, Ivy. What's up?
It's fine. It's fine. How much further do you want to go? I bet there's imps here.
Imps? What do you mean, imps right there? Oh, come on, Noelle. Do you really know what an imp looks like?
Of course I do.
Really? Have you seen one?
I've seen pictures.
Well, I've seen plenty in person. Trust me, there aren't any here. What, imps? What do you mean? Held by boss imps? Or whatever imps there are? Frozen imps? What kind of imps have you seen? Tell us now! What the heck?
We still shouldn't be this far out. There's plenty of snowflakes to study at home. And this is why you'll always stay an amateur.
Well, that's rude. Come on, man.
How are we going to impress the master with snowflakes falling from any old cloud?
No, to really improve your... You have to study the old greats. Egro, the snow from mountaintops. There are snowflakes there from hundreds of years ago.
Even so, the master can't be impressed if he's already left by the time we get back.
My dad will keep him busy until we'll stop back, trust me. Look! What do you see there? Well, I'm just, okay, so the story right there, I'm assuming that, I play as Noelle and- Shut up, cars! So I play this girl named Noelle, and we're on a little bit of a study trip with our friend. I'm assuming that's our friend, Ivy, that's her name. And for some reason, she's kind of a brat in this, so, okay, interesting. What a beautiful snowflake! Is that what I'm talking about?
It doesn't look that much different, honestly.
Look closely, see the center? Now that's craftsmanship. I study this baby, and my skills are gonna soar like stars. Noelle didn't think it was possible to improve upon perfection, but kept it to herself. Nothing has ever good enough for Ivy when it came to her snowflakes.
I'm glad you found something good. Can we go back now?
In just a bit. We didn't even climb the mountain yet. Imps would really have to show up before Ivy would be ready to return home.
If the master leaves before you get to study the snowflake, it was all for nothing.
Okay. Good point. Let's go back then.
Yes, thank you.
Oh my god. This girl, I relate to her. I like to go back home sometimes. Whenever something is boring, I just like, can we please go home? I want to go home. Yeah, I relate to you, Noelle. Don't worry. You got me right there. All right, so I guess we're going out here. Ooh, interesting colored green room right there. Everything's all green and stuff. They've returned to Ivy's place. All right, Ivy. Okay, this is Ivy's place right there. Yeah, I can tell because it's all green and stuff. Well, would you look at that? The master hasn't even showed up yet.
You should be happy about it.
I am, because I was right as usual. You worry over nothing again.
So, how is that snowflake?
Let's first try to replicate it.
Let's? As in, me too?
Excuse me.
I think we both know I have a snowflake's chance in hell.
Oh. Noelle! Oh my god, okay. Then Noelle, calm down, right?
What? Don't say that. I want to go study together, don't you? Of course, but, you know.
Then quit whining. I'll show you my secret techniques today. So do your best.
He's not even here to see me.
Your best.
Ivy.
Best! Oh my god, okay girl. Demanding, seriously.
Alright, show me then.
Okay then, let's see. They practice until evening. Oh wow, all evening for this? Wow. See, that's... Excuse me. See, that's one's not half bad. God's sakes, if I have to shut you up, you freaking cars, I swear! Compared to Ivy's creations, Noelle Snowflake looks like a turd. Oh my god, oh no, don't say that, that's so bad, come on. But it was still better than what she had managed to create previously. You could actually tell it was a snowflake at the first glance now.
Well, your secret technique did the trick, I guess.
You're welcome.
I really am thankful. I mean, maybe after a few years I can...
What? Ivy, you have a guest. Oh, that's Ivy's dad. Hey, Ivy's dad, what's up? He's here. Oh, crap. I haven't come up with any new designs lately.
Don't worry, Ivy. Your old ones are good, too. Good luck. You can do it.
Aw, such a determined friend. Yes, motivate your friend, Noelle. You got to motivate your best friend. Right there, come on. Come on, Ivy, you got this. You're coming too. Ivy's father is chit-chatting with an old friend, a master snowflake maker, who has come to see Ivy, and Ivy alone. Uh-oh. Oh god, hello there, sir. Or should I say, Mr. Santa Claus wannabe right there. This her? She big now. Can't recognize her almost, says Master Chiltialian with an accent as heavy as he is. Oh, okay then. Oh, alright, so that's Ivy's dad right there. Really nice mask you got there. That's her. How about some coffee? Do you want milk in yours? Milk's for pussies. Okay then, already up to the language I see. Okay, that's funny. I did not see this coming. All right. Oh jeez. Ugh. God. Oh jeez. All right. I'm sorry. I got off track right there. Why you laugh? Pussycat loves drinking milk. Oh, that's what he meant. Cat, of course. Ivy's father disappears into the kitchen, chuckling. Master Jolt, you know what, I'm just gonna call him Jolt because I cannot spell what the heck the name is. Master Jolt turns to Ivy and Noelle. Hello, what's up, man? Why you want to be a prejudicist? His accent really is quite thick. Of course, it is thick, as you say. Well, what can I say? I think I have a lot to offer. Yes, your mother is very good in magic too. I have big expectations. If not, I wouldn't have come. What about you?
Oh, it's me.
Me?
Yes.
Oh, I
just want to study with Ivy. Probably wasn't a good answer, but Noelle couldn't think of anything else. Lucky for her, Ivy's father comes back with the coffee. Oh, okay, father today. Come on, save me from embarrassment. So, what do you think of our little Ivy? Did you see her snowflakes yet? Huh. No need to see them here. I will look at them at the globe tomorrow.
Oh, the globe. Ooh, okay. Nice a globe right there.
Ivy's eyes lit up. She's always wanted to see her snowflakes on the big snow globe.
Ooh, I wonder what that is. What is the big snow globe in this game? I guess we're about to find out, peeps.
You could truly appreciate their beauty and details inside it. Not to even mention, this gave her an extra day to perfect the new design in her head. Tomorrow at midday exactly. Do you understand? Midday? Gotcha. I'm looking forward to it. You could come. Okay, you come too. Yes, you come too, Freckleface.
Sure. I'd love to see Ivy's snowflakes on the globe too.
And yours?
We'll see about that, I guess.
Sounds like you need milk in your coffee.
Huh?
Cause she pussy, I get it now. Why did they use that word in this game? Like, what the fudge? Like, what? Okay, that's a bit rude right there. I mean, you don't call people like that if they like milk. Oh my god, she's really making fun of her. Is Bloody Ivy making fun of us right now? That's so rude. Okay, come on.
I'm going home now.
Aw, sorry. Ivy walks Noelle halfway home. Seriously, though, show your snowflakes. Bro, can you stop calling her that? Like, come on, man. Come on, Ivy, you should be a good friend. Why are you being such a bully to her? Like, seriously.
Meow, meow, I'm okay. I don't have any illusions about my skills.
You're not even going to try? How often do you think you get to show your snowflakes to a master?
He's here for you, Ivy.
He invited you too, and you'll be there. Oh gosh. Oh, is this when we get to the friendship dynamic of being all crusty and stuff? Because it seems like it. Midday at the Snow Globe Hall. Be there or face my wrath.
Don't worry, I wouldn't miss it for the world.
And bring your A game. We're going to do this together.
I'll try, but...
That's all I needed to hear. Good. Good night. Good night, or should I say...
Meow meow.
Oh my gosh.
Enough with the cat jokes!
Noelle throws a snowball at Ivy. She misses. Gosh. Oh, you wanna fight? You wanna cat fight me? Why? Stop calling me that! Stop calling me the P word! That's rude! Oh my gosh. The scaredy cat runs home before Ivy could prepare her massive oversized snowball to break Noelle's neck with. Oh. That's right, run away before the imps come and eat you. Oh my god. Girl, calm down, really. Oh, wait, who's this? Oh, wait, that's our mother. It's our mother. Oh, welcome home, darling. Oh, hey mom, what's up? I got back from my friend who's trying to kill me with her snowball. Mother is attempting to feed Noelle's five younger siblings. Ooh, younger siblings? I'm a big sister right here. She had only ever wanted three children, but ended up pregnant again. What? Oh, okay then. And to top it all off, she got triplets this last time. Triplets? Oh my god. Okay then. Wow. Well, that's what I call a motherly figure right there. Am I right, guys? I hope you ate at Ivy's. We have nothing left but scraps. Oh, no, that's not good. Scraps? Ugh. It's one of those, isn't it, right there?
Yeah, I'm good. Don't worry about it.
So, I asked that restaurant if they need something to deliver abs for them again.
Ugh, Mom, that pays pennies!
Pennies that we need, sweetheart. If you could just hand them to people on your way to wherever.
Sounds like you already have them.
It's only 80 or so flyers. Oh gosh. So I guess we're a poor family right there, I'm assuming. Oh, that must have been bad right there. That's gotta be bad. No, none of that, Noelle. You are an adult, so stop acting like it. You can't expect to keep living here for free, while I'm killing myself to keep a roof over our heads and...
Yes, you're right. I'm sorry. I'll do it, of course.
Oh, thank you, darling. I really appreciate it. Ugh, man, I really gotta feel bad for her. Like, you know, if you live in a poor environment, that's what you gotta do, just to keep the roof on top of your heads right there. Just like Mother says right there. Noelle tells her one good night and retreats to the shared bedroom. Oh, shared. Oh, God. She doesn't even have one on her own. The next day, she leaves the house nice and early in order to head out to the restaurant flyers. But despite her best efforts, she can't get rid of them all before midday, let's say.
Ugh, I promise Ivy I'd be there for her. I should dunk these flyers into the trash where they belong.
Where they belong. Oh, gosh. Don't do that. That pays money, of course.
It's not like the restaurant owners will know. Everyone has been throwing these out anyway. Or more like I have my own promises to keep. Mom is the one who promised these ads delivered. What the hell is her problem anyway? I'm only living with her because she's the one asking me to.
Oh, don't say that to your mother like that. I know why. I get what you're going through, but it's not right to speak to your mother like that.
Why do you have so many kids? If you can't afford... No, of course. I can't just dunk them. The kids nor the flyers.
Yeah, of course, I know. Second after thoughts is always the best solution. Think otherwise before you take your actions. Think before you act. Instead, she takes them with her to the Snow Globe Hall. The Snow Globe Hall.
Ooh, that is a big snow globe right there!
The hollow to the halls of Snow Globe echoed as she adventures away.
Tasty is still in town.
She offers a flyer to a random passerby who avoids her like a plague. Oh, what, really? Come on, I'm just handing you some stuff right there.
Nothing like a hot meal to fix that attitude, sir.
Sadly, there aren't many people here.
Try some today. It's really tasty.
Gosh, shut up! Oh, well, rude. What the fudge? Okay.
Oh, good day, Master. You'll see.
Jolt. You. Oh, Yoti Lion. Oh, Yoti Lion. Okay. Utilion? Oh, it shows us right there. Oh, it shows us how to spell. Okay, Utilion. All right, that's how you say that. Utilion. Okay. I gotta remember that. Now, why you scream? It's sacred place. Shut up.
Dude, calm down. I'm just trying to
pass out flyers, bro. He commands to his booming voice that fills the whole hall.
Well, I just wanted everyone to know about these amazing meals our local restaurant offers.
She hands him one of the flyers. He takes a good long look. Beer any good?
Sure, I think.
Oh god, he wants the beer, of course. They both ogre at the ads for a good while. There isn't anything to talk about, and Ivy still hadn't showed up.
Waste of time!
What the heck, really? Come on, man, you were just talking about it and now you say waste of time? Rude. The master says finally, as he walks towards the great snow globe at the end of the hall. A magical barrier surrounding the globe becomes undone as he approaches.
Come make snowflakes.
Oh, huh? Me?
Oh, he wants us to make snowflakes? Uh-oh. Snowflakes time right there. Why don't you always ask? Yes? If I talk to you, I mean you. Make snowflakes now.
But they're not really that good.
I will see.
Already embarrassed, Noelle steps up to the globe. This is her first time standing this close to it. To make her god-awful, gosh, to think her god-awful snowflakes would be reflected at the whole hall to see in all their sloppiness. Well?
Okay.
She tries to recall all the secret techniques Ivy shared with her yesterday. Thank goodness there are barely any people. Thank goodness there are barely any people in the hall after all. Yeah, that's a good thing. You wouldn't want anyone to laugh at you for that. Because that snowflake looks like, well, what? Oh my god, of course, his face. His face is gonna be like this. Oh my god, look at her, she's blushing, that's so cute, like, look at her.
It's crap.
Why is this man so mean? Like, what the freak is wrong with you? practice. There is no denying that. She practiced while in the wind and when she was with Ivy. But alone? Hardly ever. You give ads. It's waste of time. Why not practice?
I have to make ends meet. Making snowflakes just isn't going to cut it.
Not with such bad results, no.
Yeah.
Ivy isn't here. I'm going.
Huh?
I'm going. Bye. Oh, and he leaving. Of course, he's trying to leave.
She'll be here in a bit. She's probably running late because she stayed up all night making snowflakes. It happens a lot. Please wait a little while for her.
Master looks irritated, but then pulls the restaurant ad from his pocket. What kind beer? You want to ask that again? Like, what the heck?
Oh, well, I think there was something.
They talked about beers and stews for a while. Of course, like that. Ivy walks in, looking pleased for herself. Oh, her follow follows her sooner after. Oh, okay, Ivy's here right there. Hello, hello! You're both here already? Enough time wasted. Make your snowflakes now. Gladly. Let's get right to it. Oh, gosh. Okay. Oh, gosh. Okay, sorry about that. Effortlessly, she conjures up a snowflake on the great... on the great globe. An absolutely stunning one. One that Noelle has never seen her make before. Ooh, oh my god, wow. Alright, she made a snowflake that's pretty. How's that? Just a little something I cooked up last night. Master I forgot his name. Dang it, I don't have a very good memory, guys. I'm sorry. I'm just gonna call him Jolt again. Sorry. Excuse me. Sorry. Dang it! I thought I would get that name right, but no, I'm just not good with names, guys. Alright. Master Jolt is observing the snowflake closely. He is clearly impressed. Of course he's impressed, because she's better than me. Like, what the heck? Very good. It's art, even. Heh. Thank you. Oh my gosh, of course she's better than me. Why do I always have to be the loser and she gets to be a winner? Like, why? So then it is... Is it settled? Will you be making Ivy your apprentice now? I'll think about it.
Huh?
What's there to think about? See you tomorrow. I will let you know what happens.
Wait, what about Noelle?
Done!
Huh?
What? Goodbye. Wait. Oh, I will try the beer also. Thank you for the idea. Am I going to be working with her for this thing? I think so, guys. He gives Noelle a nod, and with that, the master leaves. Alright, I'm leaving. He's always like that. Don't worry, I'm sure he'll take you under his wing. But what about you, Noelle? Of course.
Hey, wasn't impressed with me.
Mom, Ivy, and her dad gave Noelle a look of pity. Oh, pity? It makes her feel worse. Oh, man. Oh, God. Look. Come on, man. Don't look at her like that. Like, seriously.
But anyway, I need to go spread these files around.
All right. Are you coming over once you're done with that? We bought special pastries, but it looks like Master Jolt would rather drink beer. Oh, my gosh. Of course he would, because he's a drunk. So, someone's gonna have to eat his.
I got you covered.
Yep, of course. We're gonna be eating pastries, of course, while the dude right there, the master, is going to drink some beer. Only beer. Like, that's his favorite thing. Like, really, come on. Noelle gives Ivy a reassuring smile, letting her know she's okay. Even though she's not really that okay. Ugh, those things. Why do people do that? If they're not okay, then don't smile. Just to fake it. Like, really. It's not like she's expected anything different, but still, it was a bummer. Yes, indeed, it was a bummer, of course. It takes her a while to get the files handed out with a long face. The next day, Noelle is fixing one of her younger brother's socks, where there was a knock on the door. Oh my gosh, the knock on the door right there, just trying to fix up her siblings' things. It's Master Jolt, of all people. Oh no, the master.
Good day?
Oh, well, how do you know where you live? How do you know good day. Ivy's dad told me you live here.
Oh, of course. Oh, he got information. All right. I was going to assume that because he just came into my house for no reason. No one wishes he hadn't.
Come in, I guess.
Yep, he's coming in. All right. There isn't much she can offer the old man, but she heats him some water. The pipe creaks and howled ominously as she fills the pot. It's been like this for a while. They definitely have to get someone to take a look soon.
Oh, sorry, it's not coffee.
Noelle's a shame, but Master Joel doesn't seem at least bit bothered.
Well, that's good, at least.
Thank you. He takes a sip of the water.
I thought about your snowflakes. Yesterday, I said two harsh things.
Yes, you definitely did say some harsh things, man. Like, really.
Yeah, well...
Your snowflake's very ugly, but I can help.
Oh my gosh, well, you're still saying some harsh things, but okay, at least you're going to help me. Maybe you're going to help me. That's nice.
Huh?
Do you want to be a impressionist?
Oh, he wants me to be a impressionist right there already? Okay, that seems easy enough right there. I just need to do some stuff and then I'll be a impressionist. Awesome!
Noelle almost choked on her water. Did she hear that right? Her? An impressionist?
Then her and Ivy could keep making snowflakes together, like they've always talked about. But wait, there's an issue with that too.
I'd love to, really! I'm so honored!
Excuse me. But?
I can't leave my mother here alone.
Not to even mention she can't afford to move elsewhere.
Why do you think you must leave? I come over here. Set up workshop and everything. All ready for a prejudice.
Hope and excitement creeps into Noelle's heart. Is this really happening? Yes, this basically is happening right now. Master Joel looks around the house.
Your houses suck.
Of course my house sucks. Like, look at this. Like, really. You're still saying some harsh things. Even if you apologize to them, why are you still criticizing my own house?
No, Tack. It wasn't meant to be an insult. He's just completely lacks tact.
Snowflake making is study a job, even as a prejudiced.
You can work and learn. Now say yes or no. I won't ask again.
Yes!
Yep, I said yes, of course.
Good, then tomorrow first thing at morning, you know where the workshops are.
Yes, I'll be there. Thank you so much.
No need for thanks. You will work hard.
As soon as Master Jolt has left, Mom shows up squealing and clapping her hands together in excitement. Oh yeah, the mother overheard. Oh yeah, hey Mom, I'm an impressionist now, am I right?
Yes, well, you're amazing.
Someone has eavesdropping, see?
Oh, sweetie, I'm so proud of you.
Go on, say it, anything you want. I'll give it for dinners is tonight.
Already blowing my money, aren't we?
Don't be ridiculous. This is worth celebrating.
The first ever snowflake maker in our family. My daughter.
I got to go tell Ivy.
Yep, you gotta go tell your friend, saying that you'll be better than her, even though she's your friend. Ivy's father lets her in the house. Right? Hey there, Paps. How you doing?
Good, you're here.
He looks mighty serious today. Ivy's in her room. Oh, what, serious? What do you mean?
Ivy, I got some incredible news.
Oh, the room is oddly quiet. Ivy too. Uh-oh. Oh no, wait, what's happening? What's going on in here? She isn't doodling new designs or securing about as usual. Oh, what's up? Oh, crap. She looks angry. She's hangry already. Her voice is joyless. Noelle's mood drops like a boulder off a cliff. Is everything okay? I don't know. What's wrong? Oh, what do you mean? Oh, that's when the freaking thing comes in right there. That stupid old cook rejected me. Can you believe it? Oh, crap. She's angry right there. Right then and there, Noelle's world stopped with a brief moment. I don't understand.
Me neither! What's wrong with that master? I'm beyond qualified to be in the impressionist.
Oh, Ivy, I don't know what to say.
Maybe that new design was too wild, but I thought he liked it.
Screw this!
Ivy throws a bunch of her sketches into the trash.
No, don't do that! Don't throw away your art! What are you doing?
No, they're good!
Clearly not!
Uh-oh. The corner of Ivy's eyes glimmer as they're starting ripping through her sketchbook. All Noelle could do to stop Ivy is to hug her, but she does. Ivy shakes but won't cry. She has been humiliated enough. Crying would mean defeat. A few moments passed.
Oh, come on, man. Just give in to the hug. Give in to the hug, please.
What news do you have?
Oh, what?
You said you had some good news.
Oh, crap. Uh-oh. What do I say, man? What do I say?
Oh, no. I don't know what to say, guys.
Okay, so, I mean, listen. This is our friend right there. She is, you know, she wants to be in the depressionist of the snow globe thing. And, you know, everything else whatsoever. She just wants to be accepted, but she didn't. But we got accepted. So, I could be either a good friend, I would say keep it to yourself, or I have to tell her the truth, say tell her you got accepted.
Oh man, I don't even know what to say, guys. You know what, let's just go on with the story, I think. Let's say what happens if you get what happens if you tell her that you got accepted. Let's see what happens.
This isn't really the best time. I'll tell you later.
I could really use something positive right now, though. Oh no.
Uh-oh. Oh gosh, this is going to be something else, guys. This is not good. This is not good. Noelle felt strangely nervous, like she had been caught during something bad. But this is something that is going to have to be addressed sooner or later. It's better to take it out of the way. It's best to get it out of the way. Being secretive was only going to make things more difficult.
Yeah, kind of true. If you keep things to yourself, then, you know, it's going to drag out at some point. So it's best to just tell her like this.
Well, I have no idea why, but Master Jolt asked me to be his impressionist. And I said yes.
Uh-oh. The silence was expected. The disgust on Ivy's face wasn't.
Uh-oh. Oh no. This is when the friendship is about to go down, guys. Confusion or anger, maybe. But disgust?
Sorry.
Oh, crap. Oh no, she's angry. No, she's angry. Our friend's angry. No.
It's not your fault.
No, I should have waited to tell you some other time.
That's what you're sorry about?
Uh-oh. This is when things are gonna go down, isn't it?
Huh?
Sounds like you still intended to take the offer.
Oh, crap, she's angry. No, that's not good. Ivy, please listen, I can explain. I didn't know what to do. I just don't know what to do, man.
Oh, well, I mean... Noelle, how could you do this?
Obviously, I thought you were an impressionist too.
Clearly, she isn't now. She isn't, bro. Like, what in the world? Like, she can't. She's not anymore. Like, I mean, you're now the impressionist. She's not.
I thought it was both of us. Like, we were hoping for.
How the snowflakes did you get accepted and I didn't?
Yeah, that's a good question. How did I get accepted? I mean, the master knows that we can be good if we try harder, but how did she not get accepted? That's a little bit strange, isn't it?
Did you offer him something, huh? A little favor, maybe?
That's not it at all. Did you really think I would ever?
Screw you, Noelle. Get out! Oh, Mal, come on, man. Why do you have to say that to me, man? We're best buddies. Why do you have to do that to me?
Oh, no, this is when our friendship ended, man. Gosh.
Why are you so angry at me? It's not my fault you flunked, is it?
Oh, get out!
Oh, snap, no.
Ivy holds up a notebook, threatening to throw it at Noelle.
Okay, don't do that, man. Don't do that. So she leaves. Oh, man, that's not good. But not before running into Ivy's father. Uh-oh, gosh.
What's with the yelling? Is everything okay?
Ivy slams her door shut, locking herself in her room.
Oh. Probably not.
Don't take it personally. You know how much the apprenticeship meant to her.
Yeah.
I thought she'd feel better with you here. Oh my god. Gosh. I thought she'd be better with you here, since you both got rejected.
I wasn't rejected.
Oh, crap. I'm assuming that the dad's going to be jealous as well, probably. She puts on her shoes and leaves Ivy's father to process what he has heard. Yep, that's how it happens. And now the mood's all down and gloomy and stuff. Yeah, I like that. When she returns home, Mom has roasted them a whole chicken. And the potatoes even have butter on them.
Ooh, a nice dinner. That's great. Oh, I like that. Nice.
Everyone is happy and proud of Noelle. And her younger siblings are all... And her younger siblings all get their stomachs full at once. Just seeing everyone in such high spirits makes Noelle forget her worries for a bit.
I mean, at least the family is trying to cheer her up right there. Yes, she's doing the right thing by becoming an apprentice, she tells herself. Ivy could always find something else to do with herself. Noelle has to look out for her own home at once. Even though Ivy's family has been so supportive and kind to her, suddenly she felt guilty again. But shoves a piece of chicken in her mouth to forget all about it. It tastes bitter.
Ooh, and where are we now?
It's a brand new day. Noelle has arrived to Master Jolt's workshop first thing in the morning as promised. Ugh. Good tomorrow!
Good tomorrow?
What?
Ugh, no, I meant good morning. You don't say that, huh?
Oh. Good morning.
See those clouds on the floor? On the floor sits some flat clouds barely hovering off the ground.
Ooh, clouds. Ooh, that's nice. Interesting touches right there. This is really nice. I like this.
What do this week? We fill them with the snowflakes today.
Not with my snowflakes, I hope.
Yours, of course!
Of course, yes, it's gonna be her. Why else would she be here?
Now, come and watch. I teach you how to make a good snowflake.
Alright, I guess we better get going now. We better get going with the making the snowflake and stuff here.
Jill gestures Noelle towards a humongous snowflake.
Gosh. Alright, a humongous snowflake. It almost looks like a small tree.
Oh, wait, that's a snowflake?
Ooh, that looks so big, like, oh my gosh.
Mass production. See the branches? From the edges of the snowflake starts growing with more snowflakes as Jolt conjolts them up. And they drift gently downwards and land on top of the clouds, where they disappear into. The cloud gets a little fluffier.
Ooh, fluffy. Oh, they go into the clouds. Of course, snowflakes come from clouds. That's why they're poofy.
That's nice. Oh, gosh. Simple process. This snowflake design's simple also. I've made both very simple for you. Because you're simple also, eh?
Oh, gosh. Okay. Simplifies me, I see.
He is joking. He is joking, nogging. Noelle's. Oh, gosh.
We'll see if you made it simple enough.
Now, see here. Also... excuse me, my throat just caught off right there. Master shows Noelle how exactly he conjures up the snowflakes. It's the exact opposite way Ivy always taught her.
Oh, okay. She couldn't have taught me wrong on purpose, could she?
But she soon shakes the thought away.
No, she wanted us both to become apprentices. Why would she sabotage that?
Oh, she's still thinking about her friend, is she, right there? Oh.
Did you understand? Noelle tries, and after
And after some figuring out, gets a few snowflakes full of forming on some of the branches.
What do you know? It really is simple.
Good. Now get all the branches to produce.
Produce.
Yep. Was that wrong to say?
No.
Once you know this one with your eyes shut, comes to the next one. Good luck. I make us coffee.
Alright, make us coffee then. Okay, that's nice. Wait, before you go, can I ask you something?
Oh, ask away.
Why did you take me as an impressionist? What about Ivy?
Oh, yeah, she's asking him that right there. You work hard, Noelle, and you are honest.
Those are some conclusions to draw after meeting me once.
Shut up! You was on time, and you had the ads for you from work.
You should tell me to shut up. Don't say shut up to a girl, that's really rude.
So I saw you were reliable and not a stalker.
But Ivy is millions times better than me. You saw her snowflakes yourself.
Yes, she is better. Her snowflakes are so beautiful my eyes pop out of my head. I meant. Her snowflakes were so beautiful my eyes pop out of my head.
Exactly. She's really passionate about this too. You should.
But so what?
Huh?
What does it matter? It's glorious. If it's not on time, no one will see it then.
Oh, I see. Oh yeah, because snowflakes don't really last that long, really. Sometimes she just gets really inspired and forgets the time.
I don't need a prisoner who follows her inspirations down a cliff. Normal or ugly snowflakes are fine too. It all look the same on the ground anyway. Beauty has time and place. It is not that place. Make snowflakes, Noelle. Both clouds must be filled this week.
Oh, okay, so she got to fill the snowflakes inside the clouds. Got that.
Master Jolt goes to brew some coffee.
Okay.
Noelle watches her ugly snowflakes fall from the tree.
She's not sure what to think of all that.
A few hours later, Master is observing Noelle's snowflakes. The cloud is still rather slim, but has the making in a mighty cumulus.
Ooh, alright, so she's making it into a cloudy, cuddly cloud, of course. So, how are they?
Noelle is feeling a little hopeful. These are her best snowflakes, yes. Below average. Noelle is no longer hopeful. I didn't say no good. I said below average. Passable snowflakes.
Will it really be okay to send over snowflakes like these?
Of course. Only special occasions need beautiful snow. First, snow, New Year's, weddings, people will notice then. But regular snow, no one care. They only care it's there.
Somehow being a snowflake maker is less glamorous than I thought.
Only glamorous for grand snowflake masters. Now you know what it is. You still want to be a impressionist?
Of course, if you'll still have me, that is.
Your snowflakes are crap, but you are fast. Welcome to my shop.
Oh my gosh, the language of this is priceless, like, oh my gosh. Thank you.
One more thing must be done. Legal stuff, you need license.
Oh, license, of course.
Clear the test and I grant license, then you get paid per cloud filled.
Oh, nice. Right, get paid for each cloud that I fill. Nice, okay. Alright, let's see that test then.
Alright, so we're doing the test right now. Awesome. They walked over to another large snowflake tree. The design on it is more extravatic, and next to it is an even more extravatic one.
Ooh, man, there's a lot of the beautiful, extraordinary snowflake trees right there.
You already shown you can make low tier snowflakes. Now also make those two kinds and you are hired.
Ooh, they're kind of complicated. Bare minimum requirement.
Oh wait, excuse me. Bare minimum requirement. These aren't too hard.
Master Jolt kind of conjures up a few snowflakes from both trees. See? No problem. Try yourself. Noelle tries the less complicated, but still plenty complicated ones. Out comes something. It's a snowflake, but it doesn't look anything close to the example design.
Rejected! Try more!
Oh, come on, Noelle. Try harder. You gotta impress the master. Impress the snowmaster. Come on, man. You gotta do this.
Perhaps you're tired.
It's first day ever, and you feel half cloud. Go to rest. We try this tomorrow again.
What happens if I can't make these snowflakes?
Can't tire you. Noelle's a shoulder hunched a little. Then we practice more. Like we will either way. But I want to grant you license, so I can pay you also.
Oh, that's generous enough. That's a generous offer right there, man. But still, I really need to make snowflakes.
Isn't it fine if I just make the easy snowflakes?
I can't pay you if you don't have license. Then, you're a prisoner only.
Got it.
Rest, Noelle. Tomorrow, we try again.
Alright, thank you. I'll be here first thing in the morning.
As is correct. Good night.
Good night.
You'll be fine. You'll do great. You just gotta try hard and stuff. This isn't going to work. Noelle already knows it. Those two snowflake designs are too complicated for her. She needs to practice who knows how long to get them right. But the problem is, she can't afford to do that. The only reason she could accept this apprenticeship was due to the promise of getting paid for her work.
Is it back to delivering ads and scrapping for me?
Aw, come on, don't say that. Of course it's not. You're not going back to your poor self. You gotta do harder, man.
I knew this is too good to be true. I even heard Ivy to do this. I should apologize. Maybe she has cooled down by now?
Probably. Of course, just apologize to her. That's all there is today. You need to apologize to your friend. Ivy's father opens the door, but unlike usual, he doesn't invite her in.
Oh, good evening. What brings you here? Oh, he's already sad right there. I'm like, oh my gosh.
Oh, I was hoping to see Ivy.
Is she home?
Oh, come on, man. Ivy doesn't want to see you.
Oh.
I let her know you dropped by hereby, though. Have a good night.
Oh.
He closes the door.
Oh. Oh, yeah, she's no longer available in the home now. That's not good, man. Oh, come on, man. Why do you say that?
She knocks on the door again, but no one answers.
Yikes. She's that mad at me, huh?
Yeah, apparently she is. Noelle doesn't give up that easily, though. She walks around the building to Ivy's window and climbs the Vera fence. She's done this plenty of times. Whenever Ivy and her wanted a secret sleepover, she's come in like this. What's up? She knocked on the window. Ivy opens the curtains, looking pissed, of course. She's angry, of course.
Hey, man, what's up? Please don't be mad. I am sorry for becoming a prisoner. Come on, please talk to us, alright? I know I said I can be better than you, but please, just let us in.
What do you want? Just to talk. Can you let me in?
Yeah, come on, let your friend in.
Ivy rolls her eyes and opens the window for Noelle.
Yeah, come inside. Yeah, come on. Inside you go.
Say what you have to say, then leave.
What did I do to receive this kind of treatment?
You know what you did.
I don't? I accepted a job offer. Was it that bad? Look, I know you really wanted this apprenticeship, and I should have waited for a better time to tell you.
It's not the timing that's the problem.
Why? Am I not allowed to be in the prejudice without you?
Just snatch my dream away from me. What's the problem?
But regardless of if I took it or not, you weren't going to get it anyway.
Just get out.
Listen, it's not even all that. It's just grant work.
Of course it's grant work in the beginning!
But it turns out I might and not even get hired.
Ugh.
Yeah. Turns out you have to clear this set of trials for the license. And I'm too dumb for it. So, I think I have to turn down the presmanship too.
Ivy just glares at Noelle.
Yeah, it's not going to fly there, really.
Yeah, so we're both out after all.
And that's supposed to make me feel better, is it?
Yeah, I betrayed you, but it didn't pan out anyways, so it's all good. What betrayal, Ivy?
The second you know I didn't get an offer, you should have gone and turned down yours. Oh, man. I feel very bad for her for that. I mean, like, I know where she's going for, but that doesn't really excuse her for being this cruel to me. Like, seriously, don't lash out on me. Like, come on, man. That's not a real friend. That's what a real friend would have done. We were supposed to do this together.
You can't expect that. I need the money.
Money and money.
Yes, money. Do you know what it's like to not have any?
Yeah, you can tell that being poor sucks, really.
We're not all born with silver spoons up our...
Oh my god, the language in this. Like, seriously, like, what the fudge? The language, calm down, game. Like, what the heck? That's it. I'm done with this conversation. Get out!
I just want you to see this from my point of view.
And insulting me is the best way to achieve that, definitely.
Yeah, okay, I should have said that. Even though it's true.
Get out!
What does it take to put this past us? I'm sorry, okay?
Sure doesn't sound like it. You couldn't even respect the fact that I didn't want to see you today. Get the gosh, excuse me, hold on. Get the snowflakes out!
Fine.
Yep. And that's when the friendship ended right there.
Are we still friends?
Oh, there's no response. Yeah, I'm assuming you got your answer already. Perhaps Ivy wasn't sure herself. Perhaps she thought the answer was self-explanatory. Once Noelle accepted that Ivy wasn't going to speak, she leaves. Gosh. Was it over? Noelle can't say?
I think for now. I should leave her pee until she wants to talk. She'll want to talk eventually, right?
I don't know. Who knows? Gosh.
I'm an idiot! I'm such an idiot! Good job, you moron! I lost a friend over a job I can't even keep!
She thinks about how she's going to tell her mother about the license issue.
No. I have to get it now. I had to! How did Ivy get so good again? She was always studying and... Oh, that's right. There's those little snowflakes on the mountain. Maybe if I study them too, something will click?
Yeah, who knows? Maybe you can try that, probably. It's not that really believes her studying the old greats will help her. She just doesn't want to think about Ivy or go home and face her mother. So, into the forest she goes. Oh, that's when she's going to the forest. To the forest she goes. She's going to study the snowflakes. Yeah, come on, let's go. She runs until she's out of breath. Then she begins blindly picking up snowflakes, expecting a solution to all her problems to make itself apparent. But eventually the solutions are feeling shy tonight. All the snowflakes look the same to her. She wasn't able to tell which ones were made by the old greats, and which yesterday.
What the hell am I supposed to even look for? Just detailed designs or perfectly formed ones? What even makes a good snowflake anyway? Master Jill was right. Crap all looks the same on the ground. Ugh, frick!
She's just so angry, like, why are you angry? Just don't be angry there. You'll be okay. You just gotta try harder. Just try harder. Look for a good snow. Frustrations and sadness are taking over. Noelle kicks the snow, sending glimmering, sparkly snowflakes afoot. I mean, afloat, I meant. Sorry.
Snowflakes! 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 Snowflakes!
Oh! Oh, jeez.
Snowflakes you, Ivy! Snowflakes you and your dad! Snowflakes your whole family! And all the generations to come!
Oh, okay then, Noelle, calm down. Seriously.
Yes! Oh! What? Who's this?
Oh, I got a new character right there! Hello! What's up? Good evening. Oh, is this the love interest? It's the love interest right there. Hello?
Huh?
Well, this is lucky. Looks like I won't be dying alone after all.
Oh, hello. Who are you? Are you another elf? Or are you a different type of elf? Who are you?
Noelle hadn't heard the guy approaching at all. And then again, she wasn't exactly paying attention.
Pardon?
Since we're both lost, now we can freeze to death together.
Oh, I'm not lost.
And as a snow sprite, she wouldn't freeze anyway. You're not? Wonderful! Then where's the village?
You go north from...
I'm terrible at directions. Can't you walk me there? Oh, he wants her to show him around right there.
Sorry, I really need to find myself some good snowflakes.
Like, this? Oh, what? The man conjures up a snowflake. The design was quite intricate, I meant to say. I can't spell the word. Oh, he can actually... Oh, I see. He can make snowflakes. Foreshadowing right there, oh gosh. So this man must also be a snowflake maker. And a good one, too. Figures Noelle right there, I must say.
Something like that?
Huh. It's all yours. Can you take me to the village now? Oh, okay. I think we need... Oh, I see what's going on. What's going to happen right there. I'm assuming that we need his help to make the snowflakes. And in that way, we can actually become the better snowmaker because of him. Maybe that's it. Of course, maybe, yes, this should be it.
I suppose. Follow me.
Oh, they start walking. Noelle is observing the snowflake. It doesn't reveal its secrets to her either. I'm Yul. Do you have a name?
Yul?
Oh, that's a really interesting name here. I don't think I ever heard someone is called Yul, but okay, nice. What a dumb question. Of course she does.
Noelle.
Not that I'm that glad to have run into you, but what do you need with snowflakes in this hour? Isn't it dangerous to be out by yourself?
I'm studying, but it's not... But it's not really working out anyway.
Really? You seem pretty dedicated. She really isn't. You know, I've studied snowflakes myself.
Yeah, I can tell. Are you a master?
No, I am a grand... What? A grand... Oh, wait.
A grand? What does he mean by that?
A grand something? Ah, finally, we're here! Oh, we're already here, at the village. Alright, cool. He rushes inside the village. Noelle quickly follows. Oh. Now we're back at the village, right there, with this cute boy right there. At last, we're safe! Million thanks, Noelle. Aw.
No problem. What were you saying before?
I don't remember.
Oh, something about you not being a master snowflake maker?
Oh, right. No, I'm a grandmaster. Grandmaster, ooh. Okay, so that means he's legendary, I'm assuming. But he seems very young to be a grandmaster, but who knows? Anyway, how can I repay you?
Well, if you have any tips on making snowflakes, that'd be great.
You'll think about it for a bit. Oh, yeah. Oh, he's thinking about it right there. So, I take it you're having troubles.
I can't get my license. The snowflakes for it are too hard.
The man looks down at her, and also down on her. God. The man looks down at her, and also down on her, failing to hold back a smirk. Oh, a smirk?
Aw, he's smirking. That's so cute right there.
Yeah, I suck. What about it?
It's fine. There's a very simple trick to it, though. I dig it you're in the prejudice here in the village.
Yeah, why?
Well, how about you try this? Before you start casting, close your eyes, cover your ears, and imagine a snowflake you want to make.
That's it?
Yeah, it should help you focus your mind. How about you try right now? What template were you having troubles with?
Oh, I don't remember what that snowflake looks like anymore.
I can see why. This isn't working out for you. Take a look at it the next time and do what I say.
I'll try. Thank you.
She said, full of confidence and excitement. Oh, oh my god, narrating. Gosh.
It's been a long day, that's all.
Well, I'll be cheering for you. Come tell how it goes. I'll be staying here for the few days, at least.
And I'm just going to magically run into you, huh?
Nothing magical about it. Look how tiny this hellhole is.
Sorry to hear it's not to your liking.
It's not your fault. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have some sleep to catch.
Oh, well, good night.
Thanks again for helping me. Good luck with your trials.
Aw, he seems very sweet. And kind of a funny guy, too, right there. She'll need it.
Morning!
Good tomorrow!
Ha! You mocked me! But the dumb one is you. Can't even make a snowflake? Or can you? Let's see.
Alright. Noelle isn't at all confident of what she can do. Gosh. Noelle isn't at all confident that she can, so she shuts her mouth. Standing in front of the branch that gave her trouble yesterday, she absorbs the design carefully. It's really not that complicated. She closes her eyes and tries to recall the design in her mind's eye. It doesn't show up clearly, so she takes another look. This time, she can remember it somewhat accurately. So she tries to conjure it up, and... For God's sakes! Alright, so... Half-form, ugly snowflakes are back. No improvement whatsoever. Of course, same exact result. Useless.
I knew this wasn't going to work.
Of course, she tries again. Maybe she didn't focus enough. But the results are no different. Master Jolt starts telling Noelle everything wrong with her snowflakes, making it even harder to focus. Not enough fingers. You ignore detail. Looks very ugly, like my wife. Look, oh my god, that's so mean! Saying that to your own wife? Rude? Like, oh my gosh. Look here, it's... Annoyed, Noelle blocks her ears. Then, oh gosh... Noelle blocks her ears with her hands and tries to recall the design exactly as it is. Oh? Oh! Better! Oh, he knows that right there?
Huh? What?
It's better!
Jolt inspects one of the snowflakes with a magnifying glass.
Very better! Huh? Noelle, this is very, very better.
But stunned, she looks at her snowflakes. They're really miles and miles better than her last ones.
Wait, did she do it? She did it! I did these? Really?
Again, more of these.
She consoles up more. Some of the snowflakes still look like... look like trash, but a majority of them... But majority of them look gorgeous. Oh, my gosh. Oh, she's getting better and better right there. That's good. That's good stuff right there. They're not exactly as the template snowflake, but rather more intricate and detailed.
You even did the original design.
Huh?
I dumbed this down for you last night, but you did the old one. Nice.
I didn't even notice.
Great improvement. This Grandmaster qualify equality even.
Really?
The good ones, anyway. Still, some still look absolutely horrific. Now we celebrate with rum cola drinks.
Ooh, rum cola. Ooh, nice. That sounds nice right there, like that.
Oh, I don't really like...
No worries, I take the rum. You the cola, huh? Oh, he's going to take the alcohol and she's going to take the soda. Okay, that's nice right there.
All right then.
Yep, of course you're going to get some drinks right there. While Master Jolt goes to get the promised liquids, Noelle absorbs her snowflakes.
These are incredible. I have to show Ivy.
Oh, right. Ivy. Oh no, you said the word right there.
Oh, that's right. Never mind.
Oh, cheers!
Oh, cheers!
To Noelle's better snowflakes. Oh, that feels very sweet right there, my gosh. She pushes the slatter thoughts away and celebrates her new accomplishment with Master Jolt. Okay then, the last type of snowflake, final trial. Get it out of the way.
Right,
yes, do it! Just as before, she memorized the new snowflake design and starts conjuring, I meant to say, but only this time, there isn't any sign of her new skills present. All the snowflakes look abominous at best. Huh? Did I give you rum after all? Why so bad again?
Let me try again.
Same results. We celebrate too soon, I see. This is most confusing.
Oh no, she's going back to her old habits. No, what's going on with the balance and stuff?
Did you get tired again?
Well, I did focus really hard on the last ones.
In sleep, we learned things we practiced the last day. Practice, then sleep on it. It did the trick last time.
Right, maybe that was it.
Don't be disappointed like me. You made big progress today. Go sleep well. Only one more trial remains, and then you get license, and then you get paid.
Such inspiring words, Master.
Oh my god, okay, that line though, like, oh my god. Don't take that out of context, peepers. I have ways and words. Now, good night.
Yeah, but it's not even sundown.
I don't want to see you before tomorrow, so it's good night.
Alright then, good night.
While she didn't get the last trial cleared yet, Noelle is in high spirits. Right?
I can do this! I can do this after all! I should find Liu.
Wait, oh, you. Oh, she's going over to the boy right there. Oh, nice, right there.
I have to thank him for his help. Maybe he has another trick up his sleeve, too.
And as if he had been waiting, Noelle spots a Yul and, spots Yul window shopping nearby. Window shopping? The heck?
Hi!
Oh, hello, what's up, man? How you doing? Hey, how's my loser snowflake maker in the making? Oh, that's so sweet. Teasing. Oh, really? I love the teasing. Like, what the heck?
Excuse you? A lost wonder in the mountains? I'll have you know, my trial today went great.
I know.
Huh? Wait, what?
And you're welcome.
Wait, how the heck did he know that? Wait, what the fridge? What do you mean by that?
Something about the way he smiles makes Noelle uneasy. Huh?
Yeah, your advice really helped me out.
Sure. My advice. My advice that I've got you making snowflakes like these. Oh, he flinches his fingers and a bunch of snowflakes fly on Noelle's face. Oh my god, on her face. Now her face is full of snow sparkles. They're exactly like the ones she cajoled up today. The successful ones, that is, not the failures.
These?
Oh. Uh-huh.
Did you?
Yep. Noelle's heart sinked. Oh no, she's starting to feel bad right there. Oh no, don't feel bad, what are you doing?
You did your thing! Wait, is that supposed to be something she felt bad, or what happened? What the heck?
Cover your ears next time, too. So I know when to start casting.
Oh, wait, what? Wait, hold on. Is he the one that's seeing all the things? What the heck does that mean? Now it all makes sense to her. Why the snowflakes didn't feel like hers? Why they were suddenly so perfect? Oh, so he was really the one who made this, not her. What? How in the world did you not know that? Of course she couldn't have made them herself, of course. Oh, why the long face? I'm not going to tell anyone. And since we're such good friends, I even help you clear the next trial. And then you'll get your little license. Isn't that right?
Why would you do this for me?
I'm just that nice.
I mean, yeah, he's going to help you, probably. I hope.
You do me a favor, I do you a favor.
This favor is a lot bigger than me. Helping you find your way to town?
Having led me here is actually a lot more important than you think. And casting low-level snowflakes caused me absolutely nothing.
There's that word again. Casting. It sounded weird. Aggressive, even. Maybe it was because you wasn't from here, but everyone else, including Master Jolt, used Conjure.
Well, thank you. I should be going now.
Then about tomorrow?
Uh-huh.
In the last trial, remember? How are we doing this?
I don't know if we should.
Oh, come on, Noelle. Make my day. Oh, okay. Oh, wait, what do I say here? Wait, consider cheating on the trial or turn uses the offer down. Okay, so let's see here. All right, so it's stated right there is that Yul is actually doing the cheating stuff while she thought she was casting some snowflakes. It's actually him who's doing it. Wait, how does he even know to do that? Like, what the heck? How does he even... He's like, is he telepathic or something? But whatever you say here, I'm not sure as to what we should do in here. Like, we could turn down his offer, but we can also consider cheating in the rival. I don't know if it's a good thing or a bad thing. Is he meant to be a bad guy or something? I highly doubt that he's a bad guy. Like, come on, man. Who could be a bad guy like this? Right, so since we are trying to get on with our apprentice stuff here, I guess we'll consider the offer maybe? Sure, yeah. There's no way Noelle can clear the trial of her own, and she knows it. Yeah, I mean, exactly. He does make a good point right there. I mean, how could you compete with those ugly snowflakes right there? Like, really? Besides, she can make the simple snowflakes. That's what Master Jolt really needs her for anyway. Yeah, quantity over quality. The license is just a formality, right? Right? I don't know. But something is so off about this guy. Noelle can't shake the feeling that she doesn't want to owe him anything.
I'll think about it.
It's a yes or no question.
Yes, but...
Excellent! Now, in order for me to help you, you need to help me too. Oh, there it is.
I didn't say yes, I agree, it's a yes or no question. And there's so much for just to be nice, huh?
Oh god, he's a jerk character, no. He's one of those guys who's a jerk character. Like, you know those characters, any love interest characters that are jerks? Probably that, maybe.
Didn't I tell you it's a give or take? I meant to say, quite literally right after I said I'm nice.
Casting low-level snowflakes causes me nothing.
Yes, it is also something I said. What's your point? Me helping you gives you an enormous leg up in life. Let's just keep things even between us, okay?
I don't know about this. I really don't know, but...
It's windy out there. Let's continue our chat somewhere else. They take shelter in the snow globe hall. Noelle finds herself wasted wishing there were more people around for some reason.
Yeah, why are there not, like, much people around here? That's a little bit weird.
What's with the lost puppy look? I'm here to help you.
Huh.
Help me, huh?
Yes, I'm a gentle soul. who just wants to aid your poor little family. And in this instance, poor is meant literally. And little is an antonym.
Right.
But no, wait! It is the sweet, sweetest signing of alarm bells in her head that remind Noelle she hadn't said a thing about her family to this man.
Wait, what?
Oh, wait, how does she know about her family? Wait, what the fridge? Is Noelle's family being dirt poor really such common knowledge? Even tourists learned about it?
Oh, God, I must look like a...
Oh, gosh, what the heck? God, what the heck? Alright then, what the fudge? Alright then, that's a little bit weird. Something the matter?
What exactly do you need me to do?
Ah, yes. There's actually this little, thingamajig, or two, that you can get for me. The thing is, they kind of belongs to me, but I'll be needing them back.
I doubt that.
What's with that look?
Nothing. But, so, what are they, these thingamajigs?
I believe they're at your dear friend Ivy's place.
Wait, what? The Ivy?
So, he knows about her friendship? So, he knows about her friendship with Ivy, too. Busy man, this Yeel. Busy and worrisome. Nothing about the situation is sitting right with Noelle. I think I'm going home. Gotcha. Bring me the thingamajig tomorrow, and I'll give you your snowflakes.
Actually, I think I'm good.
You're not backing out from this.
Backing out? But I never agreed in the first place.
Yolse's facade drops. It sends a shiver down Noelle's spine. Oh yes, she definitely shouldn't be making friends with this one. Fine, think about it. I look forward to your answer.
Huh?
I just said, and it better be a favorable one. Until then. Oh boy, I don't even know how to think about this one right now. Seems a bit spooky right there. But I like it. Yule pats Noelle's head with a condescendingly smile. Before walking off. Oh my gosh, he butted him on the head. That's cute. I mean, I know he's giving off creepy traits here, but that's cute though. Sweetheart, you're still awake?
Oh. Yeah.
Is something wrong? Oh. Yes, something is in fact wrong. There wasn't going to be any money after all. Noelle had also taken for granted that Ivy's family would often invite her for dinner. So now they'd need to feed her every day, too. Meaning less food for the little ones. And those damn pipes just kept on creaking and howling. It was exactly bad today. It was surprising anyone could sleep at all. After someone had decided to pour themselves a glass of water.
Yeah, I'm okay. Say, Mom, what should I do if this snowflake maker stuff doesn't pan out?
Oh, I'm sure it will.
But what if it didn't?
Oh, she's trying to get her point on to her mother right there. Oh, no. This isn't going to end well, is it, this one right there? Oh, I don't know. I don't know what's going to happen. Mother looks away, crossing her arms as she often did when distressed. I suppose we just keep on going like this.
Yeah. So how is it that restaurant going? Think they need more ads delivered?
Go to bed, Noelle. You'll be just fine. Oh, crap. Oh, no, she's sending her to bed right there. This wasn't encouragement. This was an order.
Yeah, you're right. I'll be fine. Good night.
Noelle?
Yes?
I'm not saying this to scare you, but if money really is tight,
got a pretty face.
Huh?
I had to do a lot for this family to survive. I know you'll carry your weight, if that's what it comes down to.
Oh my gosh, she's just still trusting her on this. She's still trusting her, like seriously.
But none of that matters, since you're going to become a snowflake maker.
Right.
A sweet dream, sweetheart. I'm so proud of you.
Oh, I still couldn't tell the thing right there. My gosh, this must make...
That's not good right there, guys. It's not good. Sleep doesn't arrive that night. Though, if it did, she'd have jump awake anyway. A loud bane echoed from the kitchen. Uh-oh, what's going on? Followed by a continuous hissing noise, though it couldn't hear it over the younger children's screaming. Oh no, what's happening right there? The kitchen is being flooded. Wait, what? Flooded? What's going on? One of the pipes has finally burst, and was now shooting water everywhere. By the time Mother and Noelle get the stream to stop, everything is soaked. Oh, what on earth even happened?
What? I don't know. It looks like some water froze inside the pipe and it cracked open.
Froze how? I was just using it like an hour ago.
I don't know.
Oh, no. This is going to cost so much. Oh, no, the pipe. Oh, no, that means more money. No. How'd the pipe did that? Oh, no, what's going on, man? What's going on? We have to get everything tight. We have to get everything dried and the pipe itself fixed. What if there's water damage now? I can't afford it for revitalizing everything. Uh-oh. Noelle tries to soak up the water with some rags while her mother is panicking. No, this isn't real. I'm having a nightmare. This is just a nightmare, Oh gosh, it's just a nightmare because the pipe is just all, you know, stuff. Like, oh my gosh, no. Don't do that. The kids are following their mother's example and began panicking as well. You think they've all been sentenced to death. That's how loud the crying is. Everyone, shut up! No one shut up. Shut up, it's going to be fine. It's going to be fine. Did you forget I'm in the pension appendages now? Mother stops howling, and one by one, the other five follow suit. Oh my gosh, I love how the kids just follow their mother's footsteps right there. But sweetheart, I thought you said... I didn't say anything. It was just the nerves talking. Really? Yes, just ask my master. I'm doing so great. Tears and tears returned to her mother's eyes, this time from a spear relief. Oh, thank goodness! Oh, she launches herself at Noelle.
Thank goodness! Oh, hello!
Okay, so, thank goodness! Thank goodness, Noelle! You're the best! Oh, the best I am? Wait, what happened? What the heck happened? That's weird. Alright, for some reason my game just froze there for a second. Just like the game, am I right? Soon, Noelle is being crushed under the weight of everyone trying to hug her all at once. Oh, little did they know, Noelle was a liar. Uh-oh, that's not good. After soaking up most of the mess, Noelle helps to put the young ones back to bed. Mother goes to sleep too, only Noelle remains awake. Fire. She is sitting with head in her hands, trying to come up with a way to fix this mess. Obviously, she knew. There was no way of passing that trial. York's offer pops in her head, but she is quick to dismiss it. No, I'm not getting involved with that creep. Well, don't say that, man. At least he's not an old man, like, you know, like how most creeps are right there. She thinks about Ivy instead. Maybe if they could patch things up, she could help Noelle get the snowflakes right. But how could Noelle even ask after how she had hurt Ivy already? And even if Ivy did help her study, it's not like that maid may bore any resorts before. No, it wasn't going to work, but Noelle really needed the money. Ivy's family was wealthy. Maybe Ivy could give Noelle a loan instead?
Hey, I know, I just broke your trust and you hate me, but could you lend me some cash or lots of it?
I'm so screwed.
There's a gentle knock on the door. Oh, who's that? What on earth is this sour? Oh, she decided she wasn't... Okay. She decided she wasn't want to know. Okay. She decides she doesn't want to know and stays perfectly still. I know you're awake, Noelle. I could see from the window.
Oh, hello. Oh, it's you. Yule, the guy right there.
Are you kidding me? It's Yule?
Now she definitely wasn't going to open the door. Yule peers behind the window and gives her a wave.
I mean, he waves. I mean, he's just trying to be friendly right there.
How does he know where I live? Did he follow me home?
No. This just gets worse and worse.
Can I come in or what?
Oh, and that new wet rat look suits you very well.
What do you want?
For you to open the door.
You can either tell me or leave.
I don't think you can afford it for it to be so cold to me right now.
Leave before I get my mother.
Oh, your mother? Scary! Does she know about your indubitable dropping out yet?
Oh gosh, the harshness.
She doesn't, huh? Guess she wouldn't like this.
No.
Mom, Noelle's got something to tell you.
So stop it.
Noelle opens the door to push Yule away from it.
Oh my gosh. Hello?
Everything okay, sweetie?
Everything's fine. It's just some drunks yelling from outside.
Oh god. Yeah, the drunks right there.
Why are you like this?
I tried being nice, Noelle. You chose to be difficult.
Yule moves Noelle aside and helps himself inside the house. He absorbs the damp, wet mess that was in the kitchen.
Yep, this is all going to mold. Sorry about that, but I figured you needed a little motivational push.
Wait, I'm sorry, what?
Huh? Casually, as if he owned the place, Yule helps himself to a teapot. The firewood is too damp to light, though, which is fine. He figures as he spots in there wasn't any tea in the house.
Wow, you really have nothing, huh?
You're welcome to leave if you don't like it.
That's okay. It's just a little chilly.
Oh, okay then. Noah finds that a curious statement. Isn't he a snow sprite just like Kerr? How can he be cold?
But, oh wait. Maybe he's a human. Probably human? Half human or something? What is he?
But then again, he did mention something about freezing to death when they met too. Just who is he? And what?
So, now that there's no need to pretend to be friends anymore, let me tell you how this is going down.
Gosh.
Wait a minute! I know something, guys! What if this dude is actually an imp?
Because, you know, I remember in the beginning of the game when when Ivy mentioned about there being imps? What if he's actually an imp?
Who knows? Like, it could all make sense why he's, like different than her, like he's harsh. He's probably an imp. Maybe that. Who knows?
We might get to it. I really hope so, because if that's were to be the case, then that would make total sense.
You'll be paying Ivy a visit. Slip a thingamajig in your pocket and bring it to me.
You want me to steal from my friend?
Or former friend, more accurately. Though Noelle wasn't quite ready to accept that.
Technically, they're mine, but yes, extendedly.
Oh, don't be sad. They'll live without them.
Even if I wanted to, which I don't, I can't go get it. Ivy and I aren't exactly speaking right now.
I'm sure you can find your way about it. Oh gosh. One is in their living room. The sick... Oh my god.
I still don't know what these finger chicks even jar.
They're glass spheres with either an eye or a finger. Or a finger inside it. I'm sure you'll see them. You've seen them, I meant to say. And just to be clear, I want both. Noelle tries to recall. There were all kinds of weird stuff in Ivy's living room. Ivy's mother was not only the re-owned snowflake maker, but a powerful mage. That's why she is so rarely home when she wasn't stealing away imps. She was touring to show off her snowflakes.
all kinds of prizes and gizmos that landed in her living room from her travels. Nothing comes to mind. There. I've seen one from the window, and the other one should be somewhere in the house. I'll trust you'll get your hands on them tomorrow.
I already told you, Ivy won't let me in. Besides, I have to be on the work at the workshop.
Well, guess what? You're going to make this work. I'll pick you when I pick you up after work.
Wonderful.
Wonderful. It's a date, love. Oh, oh my gosh! It's a date, of course. Good night. Sleep tight. Of course. Y'all doesn't wait for a response or reply. He just leaves.
Ugh. This bunghead.
Sooner there, Lord, I think. Sooner there. Right, we're back at the workshop right there. Morning! You look awful.
Thank you. You're no catch yourself.
Are you sick? Don't come in sick. I don't want a disease.
No, I'm just tired.
If so, get the snowflakes. Final trial starts.
Actually, since I didn't get much sleep, I don't think I've learned those snowflakes yet.
I think I'll just practice the easy ones today.
That is fine. But I can't bet you yet, even if you fail clouds.
About that, I'm not so sure I get it.
Get what? Money? Yes, you don't.
You're overseeing my snowflakes, so you know they're a passable quality. The only one thing missing is the official license, so why can't I get paid?
No license, no pay.
But you'll be paying me for the same exact thing once I do have the license.
Yes.
Can't you make an exception for me until I do get it?
No special conditions. Gets confusing and illegal and annoying. You get your license soon. Hold on only a little bit.
It's just that there was this little castavulp at home.
Crying won't help you. Life is hard, Noelle. You need grift. With grift, you get to go through even gray stones.
Grift or not, Noelle makes low-level snowflakes all day long. For free. For free, of course.
Unfortunately, as promised, Yule is waiting for her after she clocks out. Alright, so got the pretty boy right there, the little jerk boy. How you doing, boy? How you doing? Oh, look at your eyes light up at the sight of me. That's funny. Let's get this over with.
I despise us. A simple little plan to get around Ivy's defenses. Even you should be able to do it.
Alright, hit me.
Can I really?
Oh. Yule reaches his hand, hopeful. Wait, what? No, don't hit him! What are you doing? Don't hit her!
As include me in one of the plans. Gosh darn you.
Gosh. Oh well, maybe next time, huh? Let's go to your place. You're going to need some pen and paper. Mother's home, hurrying the kids.
Oh, who is this? Is the boy meeting? She's showing up with the pretty boy to her mother. Oh gosh, a fellow apprentice. I hope you don't mind us doing some studying.
He sure lies fast,
because we're doing it anyway.
No, not at all. Feel free to use the kitchen.
Oh, she vanishes somewhere, but the amount of noise in the house doesn't lessen at all. The kids are playing and squealing about something or another. They're just squealing around, that's funny. It's all clearly irritating Yule, and that makes Noelle happy.
Of course, that really makes him happy right there. Enemy lovers, it's really funny.
Oh my gosh. She's sorry.
So, what's the plan?
And you're writing Ivy a heartfelt, groving apology letter.
She's not going to read it.
Noelle sits down to write it anyway. Nothing comes to mind. At least anything she hasn't already said.
I feel like I'm just picking another fight at this point.
Dear Ivy,
I reflected upon our last conversation and want to apologize. Noelle rolls her eyes. Write it. Oh gosh, tempting right there. She does, and is she told. I understand now how selfish I was and how thoughtless.
Wait, she's selfish and thoughtless too? I'm doing this all of my family while...
No one cares, just write it. Gosh, making snowflakes isn't the same without you. I just want our friendship back, though I understand if you don't. Your pen isn't moving, Noelle.
Well, the thing is, I don't know, do I want it back? I do, but not if it makes it makes the co-towing to her completely butt crap.
The language in this is just too much. Like, I can't help it, guys. The heck?
Life, if she wasn't... Like, if she had a...
Oh, God. Okay, bro. No, we're not reading that, bro. Like, calm down. Come on, man. What? If it's babies you want, I'll fill you up later. Oh, my God. What the fudge? What the... Okay, bro. Calm down.
What? No! That's just an example!
Right. The letter, Noelle.
But it's not what I want to say.
Do you honestly think this has anything to do with that? All I need is you inside the house. You're going to write whatever it takes to achieve that. Screw your friendship.
Oh, right.
Now write. Fascinating. You'll snatch just the letter from her and drops it in the mailbox. There. You're welcome.
She'll read that and know I didn't mean any of it. And anything, my fake apology is only going to make her angrier.
I doubt that. Now, when she gets in touch with you, you will reiterate what we wrote. Yes, you will. And there won't be a single excuse or but I at it.
Fine, but I think it's not going to work.
She's going to come to you, so since your house is such a pleasant place right now, you'll relocate to hers. And if you come out of that house without at least one spear, you are not getting your license. You understand?
Jeez, manipulation, come on.
Yeah.
I said, do you understand? Yes! Great! Now go be a good girl at home and wait. Maybe cut some onions to get the tears rolling.
Like I can afford any of onions right now. And you seem so confident this is going to work.
Am I supposed to believe a teenage girl's mind is somehow more complicated than this?
She's 20.
Oh, gosh. Yes. Whatever, go home before I drag you there by the hair.
I like you better when you were pretending to be nice.
Aw, she did say that. She really liked the nice version right there. Aw, poor Noelle. Why don't you go home right now? You must be tired.
I am, and I will.
But just don't get angry at me when this doesn't go the way you think. Let me worry about that. I'll drop by later.
Wonderful. Can you not make it in the middle of the night this time?
Yol doesn't deem Noelle worth responding to, nor speaking goodbye by to with that matter. He just walks away without sparing Noelle as much as a glance.
What's with the attitude? Aren't I doing you a favor right now?
I don't know. Maybe something was going on with him. Who knows? Who knows what's going on? Noelle opens the door, already done with this crap. But the one standing outside is Ivy. Oh. Oh, it's Ivy! She came! Oh no!
Huh?
She is holding Noelle's letter in her hands, in a state Noelle has never seen before. Oh.
Oh, there she is, right there! Look at her! She's crying, like, oh my gosh!
I got your letter.
Oh crap. Noelle!
Oh. She leaps into Noelle's arms.
Oh, she gave me a hug! Oh my gosh, she gave me a hug! Oh crap! It actually worked!
It is not what she isn't happy to see Ivy. She's just upset that Yul was right.
And she has said now she have no excuse not to carry on with this plan.
I didn't think you'd ever get it, you blockhead. I'm so glad you finally came around.
Ivy looks at the mess that is in their kitchen.
Hold up, what happened here?
Noelle paused it. Yes. She could already see how this is going to look. Ivy is going to think Noelle is begging for her forgiveness simply because she needs money. Noelle figures it doesn't matter if she changes the story a bit. Might as well keep going. This relationship is on its way out anyway. It's been like this for a while, yep. Like a week or so.
Oh crap, I have no idea. You should have told me. I could have at least come help clean up a bit.
Yeah, sorry. But you know, this is exactly why I needed to...
Noelle remembers what Yul told her. That she shouldn't make excuses or explain herself. The only thing that matters is getting those spears from Ivy's house.
I mean, I just didn't want to be a bother. You were so busy with your studies, since the master was coming and everything.
Oh, Noelle. I would have made time. I'd never turn my back on you when you were in need. Bullcrap. Gosh. Thanks.
Thanks, Ivy. I wish I could offer you some snacks or something, but...
Wanna come over to my place? I got snacks there.
Score.
Score, I meant. Oh, gosh.
Yeah, that'd be great.
Yep, and they're going inside the house, like the first time in weeks. Entering Ivy's place, Noelle takes special notice of all the things... Oh, gosh. All the things of display. But she can't spot any spears with eyes or fingers inside them.
You can go wait in my room.
I'll make us some hot chocolate.
Ooh, hot chocolate, nice. I love hot chocolate. Hot chocolate. This is great stuff right there.
Huh? Oh, cool, thanks.
You want it cool?
What?
Is everything okay?
Yeah, I'm lacking sleep is all.
Okay, well, you can go take a nap. I'll be right there. Oh, be right there, of course. It'd be suspicious to insist on staying here. So Noelle goes to wait in Ivy's room. Soon enough, Ivy shows up with some hot cocoa and cookies. Ta-da! The snacks! Just as the prophecy foretold. Ooh, prophecy, man, prophecy!
So you were cheering out of date this whole time. Very impressive.
Correct.
But never in a million years could I have predicted you actually apologize to me.
What a bizarre statement. Noelle is always the one to reach that first and try to talk things out. Though for Ivy, it doesn't seem to count. Unless it's a complete elite acceptance of her being right all along.
It just isn't the same without you making snowflakes.
About that, what were you going to go? What are we going to? About that, what are you going to do now? Did you step down of being in the prejudice yet? Heck no!
Did you really think I should?
Well, gee, I don't know. You don't like it, like doing it. And I don't like you doing it. Tough call, Hare. Oh my gosh. These two best friends, though, like seriously.
But I mean, you saw my house.
And Ivy's brows furrow. She takes a long sip of her chocolate drink.
Whatever, I'm not here for this. Yeah, I'm thinking of calling it quits. I just need to find something else to make money off of.
Like delivering those ads or stuff?
Like in some other things.
Don't worry, I know you'll find something. You always do.
She doesn't get it!
Gosh. Oh, I've been tinkering in some new designs. Wanna see?
Oh, sure!
I figured I'd keep at it. I'm sure some other master would take me under their wing. Oh, what is it? What's the more stuff here? You sketch more stuff? What's the sketching right there? She pulls out some sketches. There are a lot. Now, Ivy must have stayed cooped up in her room this whole time, designing away. Like this here. I can almost conjure this one. Ivy makes some snowflakes. To Noelle, they look exactly like the sketches she's shown. See? Almost there. As for these ones, Noelle is looking, but not really. Huh? Where'd that one go? Hold on, it's here somewhere. Huh?
I'll go and go use the restroom while you look.
Uh-oh. She's looking. With Ivy busy, Noelle gets back to snooping around.
There's something there.
Yul said that he could see one in the window. Right. Noelle positions herself in front of the window and lets her glance over. That's when she spots it. A small glass sphere that's rolled behind a picture frame. She yanks that sucker out of there and puts it in her pocket right there. Oh no, she's stealing it right there. Okay.
Hey Ivy, I just realized how late it is. I need to go help get the kids to bed.
Oh. Alright, are you coming over for dinner tomorrow?
Yeah, that's fine.
Why wouldn't it be, dummy? You're overthinking again. Go do your thing. I'll find that sketch drawing in the meantime.
Yeah, good night.
Good night. Oh, and Noelle?
Yeah?
I'm glad you got to pack things up. She beams a smile on Noelle. Aw, gosh, Noelle wants to die.
Me too. Bye.
Huh? Oh, she's confused by this.
I'm the worst.
She's repeating everything herself right there like, oh my gosh. Welcome home, sweetie. You were out late tonight. Oh, you know, I really love how the mother and Noelle look exactly the same. Like, I just noticed this right now. Like, it's really funny seeing that they look exactly the same. Like, do you all notice that? Yeah, I did notice that. Why is he here? Wait, what? Who? Yul waves at Noelle while sipping hot water. Oh, he's here inside her home right there. Did you have some study to complete together? Oh, jeez. He's here in my house. This pretty boy's in my house, man. I can't believe you forgot. What would Master think of that? Oh, gosh.
I didn't forget. In fact, I was looking for you.
At Ivy's? If you're going to lie, at least play along.
We should go back to the workshop and finish things up, the study partner.
The mother lets out a heavy sigh. Noelle, I really don't like you running around so late at night. Aw, don't worry. I'll bring her back. I promise. Oh. yeah, even the mother is getting so confused by this whole thing right now. Like, seriously. Like, oh my gosh. And with that, Yul drags Noelle out with him. Did you get it?
Gosh. Yeah, I have it.
Oh, she got the spears right there. She got the spears. You happy now? Noelle is about to dig the spear out of her pocket, but Yul let it roll and protested. Oh. No, just take it with you. Huh? Okay. Wait, what? Oh. Now, where are we going? Oh. Yeah, where are we going? What is this? It's not too far. It's not what I asked. And you sure know your way around now? It's only been a few days since you were lost here. Yul laughs. You still think I was lost? I guess you were just creeping around here for no reason. Excuse me, my throat is clogged up here. Creeping here for no reason, huh? Well, if it makes you feel any better, I was creeping around for you specifically. Or actually, either you or Ivy. But looking at it now, thank goodness it was your dumb that showed up. What? Oh, wait, what? He was stalking? What the fridge? Wait, he wasn't actually lost on purpose? He was looking for her specifically? What the heck? I had no idea what strings to pull with Ivy, since she's so well off. That's okay. You don't have to say anything. We're here. Oh, where are we exactly? Yul starts ascending up the mountain. It's not too steep, but it's certainly not welcoming either. They climbed up until they reached the carrots.
Ooh, where are we?
After you.
Oh, after me?
Just a reminder, my mom wants me back home alive. If I wanted you dead, this is a planned opportunity to do it in any way.
Oh, okay then.
Ooh! Look at this cave right there! The clearance opened up into a surprising large cave. And at the very back of the place, she sits a creature so perfectly still, a faint frost covering it.
Oh, is that an imp?
Oh, wait, she had never seen one in person. Wait, there was an imp right there?
Is it dead?
Oh, sealed away. Take out the spear.
Here you go.
Noelle takes the spear out of her pocket, offering to Yul. He doesn't take it. I can't touch it. Just smash it down. I need the eye from the inside it. Oh, now she wants her to do it right there.
I shattered this thing, and the eye might get cut too.
I'll take my chances.
And what exactly happens if I break the spear?
How did that if get in there? Gosh, just break it, you'll see.
It's just like a little confused and confused of what kind of horrid mistake I'm about to commit.
Hey, y'all shrugs. Gosh. Break around and find out. Oh my god, the language in this game, like, really. Listen here, you. Oh, scary, scary. What is it? Tell me. Oh my god. The teasing.
You're asking me to do for a favor right now? So to fear your example, I'm going to be a complete butt about it. And that includes me prying you all into your personal business. So spit it out! What is this about? And then I'll make it and maybe help you, maybe.
Wanting to get to know me, are we? I'm so flattered. Not. Well, alright, listen close. That's me. That thing. What? He points at the creature, sealed in place. Handsome, I know. Wait, what? Wait, is he talking about the frozen creature?
I knew it! He's an imp! I knew he was an imp right there! Is that, like,
they're talking about the frozen imp, right? That's him? And that there is your hand. That's my eye. I want it back. Simple, yes? Oh, yeah, that was him! So why is he an elf if he's an imp? What the heck?
What does it matter if you're sealed away anyway?
I only seal because parts of me are missing. How did you not know this?
Well, I'm not a mage.
Sorry, I forgot. You've been living in that village for so long. Most of you can't even use magic anymore, huh? Some snow sprites can't even make snowflakes.
So you're an imp?
What of it?
Why are you sealed away?
As I was his mother. Oh, I see. That's okay. That's starting to connect the dots right there. So he was actually an imp, and Ivy's mother sealed him of some sort and probably sealed his body parts to harvest in their own home. So that's why he knew all about the characters. I see. Well, that was a really neat twist right there. Like, he's actually an imp this whole time. I knew he was going to be an imp. I knew it. But how does he even get the body of an elf anyway, if his real body is right in the frozen there? Like, what the heck? I don't know. Well, she's not here right now, so I'm asking you. I mean, the mages don't just go around stealing every imp they see. You must have done something. Not really. I ate some brats. Oh.
Why?
Why do you think I was hungry?
You couldn't eat literally anything else?
What do you know about hunger, Noelle? You are Ivy's little lab dog. Sing and dance, and she'll throw you scraps whenever.
there aren't any Ivies around here. That brat wandered here all her own. If you're that dumb, you get what you deserve.
You got exactly what you deserve, too.
I deserve to be sealed away for the rest of my life because someone didn't look after their offspring.
You ate a child?
I was hungry.
Oh, God, no! Eat a kid? No! That's so mean! What the freak's wrong with you? Gosh! Just be happy you weren't killed off by for that.
I'd rather be killed off. Oh. Oh, crap. Oh, gosh. What kind of sick punishment is this? Just leave me to rot. Why not?
Noelle says nothing to that. Oh no. Oh no. He's hurt.
No.
Oh gosh. Yul fixes his composure. Oh no, he's hurt. No, don't be hurt. Please don't be hurt. I know. Oh gosh. All right, enough of this. I told you what you needed to hear.
It kind of just brought on more questions. Like, if that thing over there is you, why am I talking to you right now?
Yeah, exactly. Like, how is he there if he's frozen right there? Like, what the heck? Again. Right. This is just some guy I possessed.
Oh, right. So that he possessed it. Oh, he possessed a local elf.
Ah. I see. Okay. Okay, it all makes sense now.
So if I break this spear, you'll let him go?
Nah, he's dead already. I don't have enough power to possess the living. Seeing as I'm sealed off, will you break the spear already?
I still want to know.
No, exposure hour is over. Break the seal.
Fine.
Oh, Noelle throws a spear at Cecile at Yul. He covers his face with reflex, I meant to say, sorry. The force of it knocks Yul slightly off balance. Meanwhile, the spear hits the castle wall and shatters. Real mature, Noelle. Oh. Yul goes to pick up his eye. Even the remaining shards avoid him. They then walked up to his real body, and uncertainty sticks the eye back into the frozen socket. Nothing happened after that. What? Wait, what? Nothing happened? Did it, not work? No. It's working. I can tell my magic is being freed. Oh, maybe it might be able to possess a living snow sprite now. What? Oh gosh. What a face. I'm just kidding. I'm fine with live with this one. Oh, great. But I'm still missing a finger. I'm pretty sure it's somewhere at Ivy's place, too. Unless her meanie pants of a mother handed it off to someone else or something.
Okay, well, you're welcome. What about my snowflake maker license?
Indeed.
I knew it.
Come on, I'm kidding again. Lighten up. Come on, I'll help you, of course.
Will you, honestly?
Yep. I told you, I'm nice. Let's get you back home, shall we? Oh God, I know he's trying to be a jerk, but I do feel bad for him. He's very sweet on the inside. I'm sure that we are going to have a big development in this game right there. I can feel it. Noelle knows there is nothing Yul can say or do. What would make her trust him? He is either going to help her or he wasn't. All she could do was wait and see. Lead the way.
I don't like you walking behind me. Especially after your little jokes.
What jokes do you mean? Well, I can't find a dang place on my own. So you're going to have to start liking it.
What do you mean? You just came from there. How are you lost already?
I'm not. Your village is the marriage to anyone who isn't the snow sprite. How else do you think you guys have been living here so cozily all this time? Honestly, Noelle had no idea of any of this. She was starting to think scrapping by, delivering ads, and washing clothes was actually a pretty comfortable life. Oh, is she going to start realizing the importance here, I'm assuming? Oh, I think so. She's eager to get back to it. Now, if only she could get that license.
I know it's not any of my business, but what are you going to do now?
Oh, help my best friend Noelle out, of course.
Oh, he said best friend! It's me! Oh my gosh! Oh, that's so sweet!
Or if he's just saying that as a joke or something.
Ha! I mean about your missing finger.
I'm sure my darling Noelle will feel grateful to me after getting her license and help me out again.
Yeah, right. We'll see about that. It seems like a bad idea to free you. I have to think of all the children you'd eat.
It's not that there aren't any extras, at your home in particular. Noelle gives him a death glare. Oh, come on. Do you honestly think I'll be sticking around so that Ivy's mother can seal me away again? Screw that, I'm out of here the second I'm free.
Oh,
Yeah, don't you worry. I'll go eat someone else's kids. Can you stop saying that about the kids? Think of the children! Protect the children! Stop it! Like, oh my god, what is your... Why do you do that, man?
Well, that's good, I guess.
Are you going to miss me?
Oh. I'm exhausted.
Oh, she's blushing. She's blushing right there. I see her rash. It's blushing. She's blushing, man. She's blushing. They made it back to the village without an argument.
Oh, well, that's good. At least they didn't argue.
That's a good sign right there.
I'm going to try the last trial tomorrow.
That sounds good to me.
You'll make the snowflakes when I cover my ears again, right?
Boring. How about you give a little tour and go...
Wee, snowflakes has said. How about no?
It's decided then. Oh my god, this boy. I'm going to cry out of being annoyed by him by this. He's just so lovable. Like, what the fridge?
What? No, I'm not doing that.
You'll see. Good night.
That's idiotic. I'm not doing it.
Oh gosh, Yul doesn't care. He disappears off to nowhere. Probably it's said to peek through Ivy's windows, looking for the spear and the fingers in it.
I hate you.
Oh, come on, Noelle, you don't mean that. He's just so sweet. Like, come on, I know he's really rude, but he is sometimes sweet. They gotta give him that, come on. Running off homes and the lack of sleep, Noelle makes it to the workshop at time. Master Jolt is already there, as expected. Coffee?
Yes, please.
Will you do the trial today?
I'll try.
Good. We'll get right to it.
Yep, going to get right to this, of course. Noelle goes over to the tree and covers her ears, signaling to Yul she likes some snowflakes now. Not a single snowflake appears, but Noelle is already expecting that.
Of course, he wants her to do the dance. He must do the dance. What's the matter? Go on.
What's he gonna do? Noelle spins around her heel. Yay, snowflakes!
Oh, gosh. It's like, what? Like, his face after I did this, like, oh my gosh, like, what the hell is this girl's problem? My goodness.
And then nothing happens.
I knew it. He was going to deliver. I knew it.
That's when the snowflakes started forming.
Oh,
God. Noelle is quick to pretend she is the one conjoling them.
Oh, they're forming, of course! She did the dance and they're forming already!
There we go!
Very good. Very, very good.
Now, just for sure, make all snowflakes. Start with the low ones.
Okay. Did y'all hear that? Or at least figure out what I'm doing?
Oh, I don't know. Maybe both, probably. She positions herself in front of the spruce tree, glancing at the windows.
I can't see him. Oh, whatever. These are the snowflakes I can make on my own.
So she makes some. Master looks down into his nose at them.
Terrible disappointment. Oh, gosh.
What?
I thought they was going to be better since you got the other two done so well. It's still passable, right?
Okay, I meant...
Still passable, right?
Yes, still passable. Next one.
They go to the next tree. Noelle blocks her ears.
Oh, you look dumb.
Oh gosh.
It helps me focus.
Snowflakes appear.
But snowflakes look good. Next.
Oh, so I see this is a pattern, I'm assuming. Oh, pattern, probably. Noelle blocks her ears again, but snowflakes don't appear this time.
Are you kidding me? He wants me to do it again?
Oh, what's wrong? Final one. You already did them once. Relax.
Yes.
Oh, she starts spinning again.
Yay, snowflakes! I love snowflakes!
And then there are the snowflakes. Oh, shut up. Why did you do that?
I'm just terribly excited to get to make snowflakes for a living. Yep.
Make them silently.
Yes, of course. Is it done now, the trial?
Master Jolt glares at Noelle.
No.
He takes a good long look at the snowflakes Noelle just pretended to make. Then gives him a huge smile.
Oh, smile, nice!
Done! You cleared everything!
Yes!
The fact that she cheated doesn't dampen her excitement at all. Because this, this isn't about her skill. It's only about getting paid.
My mom's gonna be so happy!
I'll go write license right now. We're gonna put you to work today.
Yes!
Yes, indeed. We gotta get going, man. Master pulls open some drawers and finds a fancy paper to go to his fancy golden ink. Certificate has been pre-written. All he needs to do is sign it now. But because he is a stick-in-the-mop mud, he starts double-checking what he has written. Noelle jivers about.
Oh, gosh. Oh, come on, hurry up! Why does this take so long? Come on!
There's a knock at the door. Oh, what? Go away! Go away, man!
Exactly, thank you!
Sorry. It's pretty important, though. It's obvious, father. Oh, no. Master Jolt pulls the papers down.
No, just sign the dang thing, you old fool!
Oh my god, everyone's just so mean-spirited, man. What happened? Oh god. Noelle's father glimpsed at Noelle. Uh-oh. Sorry, Noelle. Could you give us a moment?
Of course, let me just get my license real quick!
This looks serious. It is! The thing I was telling you about the other day, it's gone missing! Uh-oh, he's talking about the spear thing, probably. Find it then. I've been looking. It's nowhere in the house. And you said it sensed an imp ahead. Excuse me. And you said you sent the imp around. So I'm thinking, shut your muzzle. You scared Noelle. Whatever, she can handle it. No, she's a pussy. God, oh my god. Everyone is still using that word, like, seriously. Well, I think they're determining that it's a cat meaning, but I really just can't understand why they use that, really. We can go talk in your home. Noelle, you can go home too. Your home.
But what about...
Later. It's more important now. Where is it last?
On the shelf.
Like I showed you. Don't know why you put it on display at all, so stupid. I'm just proud of my wife.
Yeah, he's proud of your wife. So come on, don't say that to him. Like, really.
Ivy's father and Master Jolt leave.
Ugh, are you kidding me?
Yes. Oh, you were so close. Too bad. I fulfilled my end of the bargain now, though.
He'll just sign it later.
I didn't think they'd notice the spear missing so fast.
This really isn't any of my business anymore.
I'm thinking of possessing your mother, killing your siblings, and eating them for breakfast.
Oh, come on, what the heck? Why would you say that? Stop it!
Wow. Quite the appetite you got. There are snow sprites. They'll keep. And then again, if you could get me the last spear, I could just leave.
You have some incredible powers of perfection in.
Aw, but you know what I mean it. I gave you your snow and the snowflakes and everything. You've come this far. Let's see this through to the end, okay?
What would I?
Because of what I'm going to do to you if you don't. Helping unseal this thing wasn't Noelle's best idea, but she already knew that. Still, all she needs to do is to finish what she started. Then Joel will, will move out somewhere to be someone else's problem. And Noelle can go back to her new life as a suspect, I guess. Oh gosh, as a soul, as a snowflake maker. What's one more imp in the wilderness to her?
Gosh. What did you have in mind?
I'm possessing Ivy's dad and making him kill himself. Then you could pick up the spear and, oh my gosh.
No! I will not get tangled up in some murder investigation. Besides, Master Jolt is there. Who knows? He might blast it and boss you into smithereens in before you could do anything. On second thought, sure. Let's try your idea.
Actually, it doesn't matter one way or another. How do you get it? Now get going. Let's just go get going.
How is it screws your life up, but it is your problem. Gosh.
Gosh. Yo gives Noelle a shove towards the doors.
Hey!
Chop chop, time's wasting. Oh my gosh. Wow. They're bound to at least discuss the other spear. Keep your eyes and ears peered.
Ugh, fine.
Then Noelle leaves to go hang out with Ivy, of course. An icy wind pushes her behind, almost sending her flying face first into the pavement. Wait, what? Oh no, she slipped. I think she slipped. Oops, I only meant to give you a little burst.
Gosh. Ah, well, don't!
Oh my god, these two are inseparable, aren't they? Mo arrives at Ivy's place. Master Jolt and Ivy's father aren't there.
Oh, you're here. You're early today.
Oh, there's Ivy. What's up, Ivy? How you doing, Ivy? What's up?
Since I didn't have any gigs today, it's unusual that your dad isn't home. Where is he?
He and that master just went off somewhere.
Crap, I missed them then! But I found that drawing I couldn't find yesterday. Nice, think he'll come back soon. Who cares? Just take a look.
Oh, take a look at this? Alright. Here! Ivy shows her design sketch, and then kinda concerns up a snow... Up a snowflake of it. Snowflake like that. I think it's my best one yet. What do you think? Absolutely nothing.
Wow, yeah, that's amazing. How did you even come up with that?
Yeah, she just uses her imagination, that's all. Ivy starts explaining her process in detail, while Noelle peeks out the window. Of course, not a sight of Jolt or Ivy's father to be found.
You seem kind of
fidgety today. What's up?
Just wondering if they're coming back anytime soon.
Dad and Jolt?
Yeah.
Something seems to click for Ivy. And then, she gives Noelle a knowing smile. Ah, you're nervous about quitting.
Huh?
Since my dad and Jolt were here without you, I'm guessing you were a no-show today.
Were they mad?
Oh, they were so mad. You're gonna get it.
Yikes.
Oh my gosh. These two. The biggerness in this game. Seriously.
They'll be back soon, I'm sure.
Don't worry. I'll back you up when you turn him down.
Oh, no, you don't. You will not screw this up for me now, I swear to God! Thanks, Ivy. I really want to tell him myself, though. I was kind of hoping he was here, actually, so I could tell him now. Wait, that doesn't add up. I had have been up after work to quit. Since I showed up late today, and he had already left somewhere, so I figured I'd come looking for him here.
Ivy didn't think anything was off, until Noelle starts pethering on all that useless information.
Okay. Oh, could I get some water?
Sure, it's just water?
Yeah, water's fine.
Ivy goes to get it. Noelle follows her out of the room. The only difference is that something is sitting on the couch, wrapped inside the cloth. It looks forgotten, so Noelle takes a peek. Jackpot! What? Inside is a spear that is a ghoulish finger inside. Whoa, wait, inside the bloody... Wait, what's up with the music? What the heck? Wait, it's inside the bloody cushions of the couch? What the fridge? That's a weird place to put the spear at. Like, what the heck? Into her pocket it goes. Yes, here you go. Yes. What? God. Ivy spots the now empty fragment of fabric at the couch. Oh shoot, Dad forgot this. She takes the fabric, only to notice it's strangely light. Oh, wait, where's the... Oh no, not again. Another friendship blowout thingamajig right there.
What?
There was supposed to be this glass sphere inside. Did you happen to see it? Once upon a time, not too long ago, Noelle felt bad about lying to not Ivy. But at this point, it's become second nature.
Then I guess your dad didn't forget it after all.
Oh yeah, I guess so. Oh, crisis avert.
Quick, change the subject. What's the seer of a spear for anyway?
It's a part of the spell that keeps some imps sealed off. We used to have two, actually, but the other went missing. Oh, there were two of them? Oh, interesting.
That sounds pretty bad.
It's okay. My mom's not here right now. So, John said he'd take care of it. They'll unseal the imp and then kill it.
I kind of wonder why they don't just kill them in the first place.
Yeah, I've always wondered that too. I don't know. Murder is bad. There's the naive hope that they'll repent. If they do, the seal comes undone. Which happens never, I bet? I don't know much of it. Honestly. Oh, yeah. Oh, here it is. Oh my god. Oh my gosh, really?
Stop calling me that, man. Stop calling me that. Why do you gotta call me that? Like, seriously. Like, come on, man. Come on.
Seriously, just quit and get it over with. He won't mind.
It's just an apprenticeship. It's not like you're turning down being his bride or something. Oh, God. Gross. No. Gross. I will not accept that.
But he seems busy, and now with that imp stuff, I'll just tell them tomorrow by myself. Fine. Let's go hang out somewhere else instead.
Oh, no. Hang out. She's gonna find it, I'm assuming. The snow globe hall is peaceful as always. Oh, look! They switched snowflakes! Oh, snowflakes? They have? I can't tell the difference at all.
They're not half bad. Who made them?
Let's see. Oh. While Ivy is reading the credits plate, Noelle spots Yul. He beckons her to come closer. Oh,
not right now. Can't he see I'm with Ivy?
Not. Yes, he can, but he doesn't care. Never heard of this snowflake maker before, have you?
No, never!
Oh gosh, there he is! What's up, man? What's up? Fancy running you here!
Oh, hi. Oh, who's this?
A friend. Minding if I bother Noelle for a bit?
I mind. Who are you? Noelle, do you know this guy? He's a fellow student.
I see. I bet you're here to pester Noelle about the apprenticeship. Oh, well, so don't bother. Her mind's made up. Oh, crap. Oh, no. Defending right there. Defend the stuff, man. What not to give to someone who she just met? We're busy. Come on, Noelle. Let's get out of here. Ivy pulls Noelle's hand. Yul grabs the other. Oh, no. I said I'm bothering her. And I said...
It's fine.
Huh? It'll only be a minute. Noelle lets herself get dragged to the side. Ivy doesn't take her eyes off of her. She sure is alert. Listen, something is wrong. What? Oh, wait, what's going on? Yeah, she's not usually that snappy. No, stupid, I mean our situation. Looking at him now, Yul seems sickly. He's worn out and shivering. Oh, he is? What's going on? Seeing him in such a state was actually quite refreshing. Noelle wonders if it's sympathetic of her to find him a little cute like this.
Ooh! Ooh! She found something! Ooh, she find him cute like this! Ooh!
Oh my goodness, bro! Oh my goodness, Noelle, girl! Like, oh my gosh! Oh my gosh, I saw those two leave the village a while ago. What's going on? Tell me. Oh, well, I got the... Oh. He blocks her mouth with his hand. Oh, God, glad to hear it. Just like everyone else around here hears you. Oh, right, well, I know what's going on, and I wouldn't be worried. Of course you're not. This is me we're talking about.
Ha! If you're that worried, why don't you go see what's up yourself?
What do you think, I'm an idiot? I'm not walking out of here without you.
Then you're going to have to wait until later tonight, because if we go now, won't we just run into them?
Ugh, yeah, I'll come get you.
Ned, are you going to be okay?
The frick do you care? I'll see you later.
Well, jeez, I just...
Come on, man, she's starting to care for you, man, just starting to care, bro, come on. Yul leaves as abruptly as ever.
That's it! I don't!
Oh, what did he want?
To pee me off, of course.
Who is he? I don't really know, actually. Well, I mean, he's my fellow and a fellow he's my fellow prejudice, so we just met recently. Well, I don't like him. Same. He gives me a bad vibe. You get used to it. What was that about seeing him later? I'm handling over some work stuff since I won't be needing him anymore. Like what? Like, just stuff. What does it matter? Oh no. Fight. What? I'm just curious, so what kind of stuff? It's nothing important. Oh no, not the tick thing again. That means the fight's gonna happen, man.
What?
It just kind of feels like you're pushing me away lately. Oh, come on. Ever since you got accepted as the freshman, you've changed.
Changed how?
I don't know. You're just kind of being kind of snarky and distant.
I am not.
Guess it all went to your head, huh?
It did not.
Did too. Gosh.
Fine, so I'm a butthole now. Is that what you're telling me that you're trying to tell me?
No, I'm only telling you this as a friend. I don't want you to get invested by guys like that. Or by idiotic masters who doesn't want you to want your cheap labor, for that matter. Alright. Got it. Thanks. Oh my god, okay! Jeez, that's your friend! Like, Noelle, come on! Can you stop calling her that? Like, seriously! As long as you get it. Gosh. Noelle, why are you being so rude to her? Like, you just apologized. Well, kind of, you did apologize to her, and then she forgave you, and you're calling her that? Like, seriously, what the heck?
Well, you're giving me a lot to think about. So I'm gonna go home right now and just do that.
See you tomorrow.
Yeah, sure.
After a few hours, Noelle has managed to twist and turn everything around in her head. Yes.
Of course she doesn't want to get invested by anything that isn't her. I'm supposed to be this talentless charity case that makes you look good after all.
There's a knock on the door. Oh, knock on the door. Oh, there you are, man. He's here. He came back right there. About time you showed up. Yeah.
That's all? Just, yeah?
Yeah, let's get going. Snap. Just get going, man. Just get going.
What's wrong? You're slow.
I have no idea.
Maybe that corpse is about to give?
No, it's something else.
Is there anything I can do?
You can back off. How about that?
I'm just trying to be nice.
Well, don't.
Fine.
Oh, he just doesn't want to be nice. Come on, man. Be nice. Like, come on.
She kicks him in the spleen.
A spleen? What the heck? Ah! Do you want... do you want me to kick your butt? Gosh.
Miss complication. I thought you said not to be nice, so I just figured.
I'm dying or something. Can you not?
I just want to play.
What?
My best friend told me I'm a butthole. So I'm looking for another one.
A butthole?
A friend! No, you're both. How about it?
Well, you have been useful so far. It depends on the benefits, really.
Now, I'm not sure if that's a double-level industry, but...
Ha! It wasn't! When it comes to that, you don't quite... He gestures towards her chest. Oh, gestures toward... Wait, what's going on? The torso chest? Feel the requirements. Oh.
Screw you, butthole!
Gosh, everyone's just so insulting. Weren't you looking for one? Mission accomplished.
I'm glad you're self-aware, but I said I'm looking for a friend.
Semitics? We're here. Oh, we're here. Oh, back to the cave. Back to the cave I see right there.
Ah, look! Footprints!
Footprints, what the heck? I'll take that as Ivy's dad and the old guy that dropped by. Ivy said
their plan is to unseal you and kill you at the spot. But I had the spear, so I guess they couldn't do anything in the end.
No, they did something. What? The frozen imp, or Ailes' body, but before it's gone. In this place is a pile of rubble. Upon further inspection, it turns out to be the imp's body, shattered in itty-bitty pieces. Wait, what?
Oh no, wait, what?
Wait, what? Oh no, 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 oh gosh! The Ibs' body! It's destroyed with the fridge!
This explains why I've been under the weather today. Since they couldn't unseal me, they broke me. Instead, a little childish, don't you think? Oh no, they destroyed his body and now he's stuck as this! Oh no, that's not good! Why did they do that? I know he's a monster, but they didn't have to go do that, like seriously! I guess they figured, even if he did get unsealed now, you died from the injuries.
Injuries?
Okay, excuse me, gosh. Go ahead.
I guess they figured, even if you did, if you get unsealed now, you died from the injuries.
Injuries is such a just a gentle word of what I'm looking at. Yor kicks one of the pieces closest to the main pile. Oh, well, there's not much else to say.
What do you want to do about the spear now?
Keep it in your pocket if you want to keep up appearances. You want her to keep it? Well, that's interesting. Oh, there's a faint echo of snow crunching under someone's feet. It's approaching slowly. It's a little hard to see in the darkness, but Noelle wouldn't mistake that silhouette. But who's that?
Ivy?
Oh no! Oh crap, it's Ivy! She's here! Oh no, she's here! What the heck? She came over!
What are you doing here?
Oh, she sasses us while wandering off here all by herself in the middle of the night. I know you're up to something. I just wanted to make sure Noelle's okay. So, you stalked her? How nice of you. Pods of the pots and pendles. Thanks, Ivy. I'm fine. What's going on in here? Do you even know what place this is? Well, want me to take care of it? Oh, take care of what? Noelle had a pretty good idea what Yol's taking care of would entail. Wait, what? And though she accepted her and Ivy's relationship has come to an end, she doesn't want to harm her. No, harming her would definitely harm her own chances of living peacefully. Wait, well, Ivy, it's a great thing you walked in now. Any later, you wouldn't have gotten an eyeful. What do you mean? What does it look like? I came here to screw my boyfriend. Screw? Wait, boyfriend? You say? What the heck? Yo, wait, is she just covering up something or what? Yol chokes back a laugh. Come on now, keep it together.
Boyfriend? I thought you said you didn't even like him.
So?
Who says you have to like your boyfriend? Common sense?
Anyway, you know my place has no privacy. God, I was worried. You could have just told me you were dating. I was about to, but you already gave me a lecture today before I had the chance. Well, I mean, was I wrong? I don't think so.
Either way, now you do. And while you're at it, you should know another thing.
I've decided to keep being a snowflake maker apprentice. Because he told you to? No, because I need the money. It would have been nice if we studied together, but it just didn't work out that way. We could have tried again, asked some other master. I think we both know I was never going to make it. Just was my only chance. Ivy sighs and shakes her head. What happened to you? It's like I don't even know you anymore. Noelle shrugs. Sorry. No, I'm the one who's sorry for interrupting you two or whatever. I hope your career takes off. I'll be taking off now too. Be careful, it's dark out there. You be careful too, Noelle.
Oh no, she's already upset. Oh no, that's not good, man, that's not good. Oh God, oh goodness, man.
The emotion, she has to stick up for herself, man, like come on. Ivy gives Yol one last judgmental glare before she leaves. Noelle watches her go. She was expecting it to hurt, but it didn't. Wait, it didn't hurt her? What the heck?
What do you think? Will she still be friends with me?
It beats me, girlfriend. Oh, now he calls her girlfriend right there. Oh my gosh. That was the only excuse I could think of.
It was a good one, right?
She's gone now. Be the break to break the spear.
Are you sure?
I want the rest of my magic back. Even if I have to stay in this lamp corpse.
Don't say it. Either one like that better than your actual body.
Oh. Oh, she's encouraging it with the body. Oh my gosh. Wow, thanks. I didn't think you'd be into necrophilia. No.
No, man, what the fudge, man? What the fridge, really? I'm not!
Then what's with the preferences? Oh, God.
Like, aesthetics! I got used to this! I don't know!
Then again, I'm assuming this even works.
Yul starts gathering up all the pieces to a shattered body into a pile. Noelle breaks the spear and hands Yul his finger.
If I die, you have my permission to enjoy yourself.
I'm not a necro- Oh my god, bro. What the heck is this? This is funny, like what the heck? And is that your permission to give anyway?
It's not, it's my body now. The previous owner left already. Considering this is the hand-me-down, if you will.
Oh. He places his finger on top of the pile. With a couple of seconds, it looks like nothing happens.
Frick!
Oh! Hey, Yul drops onto the cave floor and starts screaming. Wait, what? Wait, it didn't work? Like, Frick, that hurts!
Ah! Oh, God! But, well, you live?
The original body absolutely didn't live. Blood bores out of no longer frozen pieces, turning the pile into a gory mess.
Oh my god, wait, what?
Meanwhile, Yul's screaming increases. He's gasping for air, currently up into the ground.
I have no idea what to do.
I think it's passing.
Thank goodness.
Wait, oh god, oh, that's,
wait, what, is he okay? Is he dying? What happened? Was he just feeling the pain? It's like, oh god, my pain hurts.
Oh, that's gonna suck, man. Gosh, dying sucks.
Did you at least get all your magic back?
Not even. I tried to possess his body with my whole being, but couldn't manage much too much before the pain started. Then my body died and everything still inside died with it. So I got basically freaked all.
Gosh, sorry to hear that.
It takes a couple more breaths, this time to calm down.
No matter. That's done now. Thank you for your assistance.
Aw. You won't eat my family now, right?
I won't.
Great! So, what will you do?
Not sure. What would you do?
Well, once Master Joel signs that license, I'm going to make money. She'll say I owe it to her for this and that and then some. But at least we'll be back on track financially.
Oh, well, that's great. I guess you just gotta sign in and stuff here. But the question is, will you work out with your friendship with your friend and the friend still? Like, she seems like she's going to stay away from you right there.
And then I'll just regret my life, I guess.
Maybe make amends with Ivy again. So, she can't keep telling me what a no-good piece of crap I am.
Such a joyous existence.
And you? You go somewhere back to your friends and eat a bunch of kids?
Like, oh my gosh. I go back now, and I'm the one who gets eaten.
Oh, that's right. You'll have to live as a fake snow sprite now.
Uh-huh. Oh, right, that's right. So, since he can't even get to his body now, he's stuck like this.
Then come live with me, in the village.
And that's Ion, a kind of a house? Pass. Maybe you get your own place? I'll think about it.
Mom expects me to live with her, though. Especially now that I'll be her cash cow.
Oh my gosh. Cash cow, just like my parents, of course. What is she going to do when you marry?
Oh, why? Are you offering?
Oh, what's this? Okay, here's what this is going down. You'll get your own place, and I'll crash here until something better comes around. Oh, snap, he's gonna think about it, guys, he's gonna think about it!
Well, say no more, I'm sold!
Since you get paid by a cloud fill, I'll help you with that.
That's surprisingly nice of you.
Yes, I can't be and exceedingly nice if it benefits me.
But I still have to pay for my mom's house, too. I don't think I can afford 2 pieces even if with your help.
Who said you're allowed to make those decisions? I'm going to be your psychotic husband who controls not only the money, but who you're allowed to talk to. Oh, God. I wonder if that's supposed to be a joke or whatever. I'm sure he's joking. He's joking. This man, though.
Then why would I stay with you?
Because life with me is so dizzying and intoxicating that nothing feels like anything in my absence.
My God.
I will be, yes.
Aw, so cute. I swear to God, it's so cute, guys.
Well, are you game?
With those rules? Heck no. But we can live together. And I'll use you as an excuse as to why I can't send all my money to Mom. I'll say you're saving for the family or something.
I did say I'd give you that.
You did?
In passing, I didn't mean it, though. Kind of think of it. Would the baby be a snow sprite or imp or some undead abomination? Oh, God, he's considering kids. Oh, no. All three.
Come on, then. Let's go back and get this catalog started.
Oh, man. All right, so they're going now. They're going back to the village, and they're going to get things straight up right there. They're going to get the job. You're going to have to walk me there.
And you need to take care of not to not get spotted by mains.
mages. Oh, yeah, mages. You can't be spotted by mages.
Just in case they can tell you who you really are.
Before we go, help me bury my corpse.
Do we have to?
If you liked, we can bury you instead.
Oh, scary.
You'll see me scary yet, love. Oh my God. These guys are inseparable. Inseparable, guys. Inseparable duo, am I right?
Ha! You don't even know what scary is until you foolishly eat the last of my potato salad.
I've never had that. Is it supposed to be good?
Oh, yeah! But way better than dead children. You'll see.
Now, how can you say that when you never even tried?
How do you know if I have or haven't? You don't know me, babe.
Babe! Now he's calling her babe. She's calling him babe right there.
Do you know I used to have 6 siblings instead of 5?
Oh, wait. 6? Wait, she used to have 6 siblings? But where was the other one? What happened to the last one? What the heck? He got lost? Oh, I hope he got lost. Like, what the heck? Okay, just kidding. That never happened. Oh, okay. Whew, don't scare me like that. Like, Noelle, come on.
Or did it?
No! Oh, gosh. It's quite an ordeal to dig the grave into the frozen ground. But they get it done. Oh, I get it done. Oh my gosh. There's a nice little picture right there. Oh, that is so cute right there. Oh my gosh. It was by far the least troublesome ordeal they ever got themselves into. It's like marrying someone you could barely torment is a bad idea or something. Regardless, they stuck together in a cozy place of their own, making snowflakes. And also enemies out of the forks around them. Aww, a soon and there married couple. That is so cute right there. Do you even love me? Sometimes. They're just so inseparable right there. Every day they bring out the worst in each other. Sometimes just for the hell of it. Mostly for the hell of it, honestly. You'll end. Yay! That was just so cute right there. It was just so funny right there. Well, guys, so excuse me, sorry. Oh, the reading is making me tired right there. This was such a fun ending right there. That was just so sweet and so funny at the same time. So yes, that was us playing No Good Noelle, and this was a really fun, sweet little visual novel game. I really loved the art style, and I loved the story and everything whatsoever. It was so much fun. I enjoyed every bit of it, and I also loved the ending. I know there's actually 2 endings, I'm assuming, but I'm sticking with this one because, well, I don't really want to edit so much of it, so we're just gonna leave it to that. This is the canon ending. Canon!
What an ending, I tell you!
But so, yeah, without further ado, I guess this might be a good time to end today's video right there. So, yes, thank you guys so much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed today's video. Make sure you go subscribe to my channel and give me a lot of likes and subscribes or anything, or try to be awesome like me. And hopefully you're looking forward for new videos in the future. So, there we go now, and bye, guys! Yeah, boy!